players here all the way from the easy bottom with their SpongeBob themed banners. Don't be a barnacle. Come out and support them on October 7th for their Volley for the Cure match.
They're not ours. They're not ours.
Sit down.
Benjamin Logan FFA is made up of over 100 students who specialize in agricultural literacy and agriculture advocacy. We wish all of the Raider athletes good luck. Under the sea, back 40 years with the class of 1983. We celebrated our 40-year class reunion in June and made the decision to have a class gathering every month instead of waiting another 5 or 10 years. We are making the most of our time that we all have left. The class of 1983, along with our own 1983's homecoming queen, Robin Stevenson Crockleton, would like to wish you good luck on your game against the Lakers. Go Raiders! Benjamin Logan Youth Cheer is coached by Holly Miller, Rachel Wren, Casey Marble, and Christy Daniels. Youth Cheer is open to grades 3 through 6. They have 42 girls participating and working hard cheering for your favorite Raiders. Come watch them on Cheer on Thursday nights starting at 5:30, now through October 17th. Raider Youth Football is open to grades 3 through 6. This year, we have over 80 athletes participating and working hard to one day play under these Friday night lights. Games are held Tuesday nights starting at 5:30, now through October 17th. Come out and support your Raider Youth.
Those old, the years they were queen or whatever?
Has anybody ever eaten a Big Mac? I've never eaten a Big Mac, but I'm starving, so she's got a Big Mac. Of course, it's not that big. So she's eating fries and Big Macs, and she got home and cookies, and she's like, oh my God.
by Class President Riley Norville and Vice President Bree Allen. Wishing luck to the boys tonight and congratulations to our attendants. Go Raiders! Class of 2024 is representing homecoming and their grade with a Little Mermaid inspired banner.
The freshman didn't attend, or Trish didn't tell Mrs. Rodriguez that the freshman needed to be there.
Benjamin Logan's past homecoming queens are back and ready to cheer on the football team. Tonight we celebrate Benjamin Logan's roots. We were many towns that became one district, and we want to recognize all of our communities that make up Raider Nation. We are lucky enough to have some very special representatives for our consolidation. Tonight, we not only have queens that represent Benjamin Logan, but we also have royalty from Bell Center, Logan Hills, and Buckeye Local. These ladies are proudly wearing their school's colors. The queens present tonight span from graduating classes of 1954 to last year's graduating class. We would love to recognize Bell Center's 1954 and 1955 queens, Lillian Ross Houchin and Lois Ann Richardson. Coming together is a beginning, keeping together is a process, working together is success. Go Raiders! All banners will be displayed under the scoreboard on the fence. Thank you to all the groups who participated in our parade. Another round of applause for our former queens.
Thank you. done by 6:40. You're saying you can't wait until then. They need to go out home.
But like for the third grade teacher,
Yeah, I have to talk to her.
How are you?
I just got a note from Brady. I asked him if he was at the Logan. What the heck, Gretchen?
I may have not told him.
Take a selfie with
us. He goes to these like 4 miles walks, so I didn't want him to feel like he had to come here, but I was just gonna stand up there.
I figured he was coming as he asked me what type of chicken.
Ladies and gentlemen, the results of the coin toss tonight, Benjamin Logan won the toss and has chosen to receive the ball to begin the game.
Glad I get to have you again.
such long shite, we're able to mend the person. Thank you for making my day.
Cross-country team.
soccer, track, and is the FFA treasurer. Outside of school, Miley enjoys raising and showing cattle at the Logan County Fair, running, working at Pop's Pizza Parlor in East Liberty, and attends Christ Our King Church. Miley is being escorted by Evan Carpenter. Evan is the son of Chad and Ann Carpenter. Evan is involved in soccer, wrestling, track, Business Professionals of America, band, youth allocations, and National Honor Society. Outside of school, Evan enjoys hanging out with friends and family, lifting, traveling, boating, and water sports. He is also a member of the West Mansfield Methodist Church. Your second 2023 meet and key candidates are Madeline Harmon and Ben Chamberlain.
Thank you. Welcome to the broadcast booth here at Benjamin Logan High School on 98.3 WPKO and PeakofOhioTV.com. It's week number 7 in high school football. With Rick Zedeker, I'm Chad Wilkinson. Tonight, Rick, we get the old backyard brawl here as it's a homecoming for Benjamin Logan. The Raiders in here at 1-5 on the season will be taking on the 4-2 Indian Lake Lakers. Looking forward to this game.
Yeah, it's going to be a good game coming out here to tonight here at Benjamin Logan Stadium. Our second trip out here to see the Raiders' new facilities and new field. So I'm excited to come back out here again. It's always a great rivalry, backyard brawl. You know, you kind of throw the records you mentioned a second ago. You know, Benjamin Logan 1-5, and with the Lakers coming in here at 4-2, that record kind of goes out the window here when we get this backyard rival game going on here between these two teams.
And really, I mean, it's the second season because both teams are 1-0 in the Mad River.
Yeah, and so that's pretty impressive. You know, both we opened the Mad River, the CBC Mad River Division. A lot of interleague games came to start last week. And so for both of them to start off 1-0, again, it's a whole new season. You know, they're looking to try to win their conference and go on and try to do something in the playoffs.
Let's talk about Benjamin Logan. I mean, they're 1-5. They got their first win of the year last week, and what a thrilling win it was at Northwestern.
Yeah, they had that one against Northwestern. So what was interesting about that game is, you know, they were actually down 13-0 at one point, the Benjamin Logan Raiders were, and ride all the way back to take a 19-13 lead. And I tell you what, it did not end without fireworks there at the end, as the Raiders made a goal line stand there at the end of the game to keep Northwestern from punching it in there and getting their first dub of the year.
So the Raiders really stepped up big time. Coach Jenny, we just heard him in the pregame show a few moments ago. His team, he's seeing improvement each week, and it's just, it's just a whole different ball club now as you come in here and you got that first win under your belt. They no longer have that zero hanging over them.
Yeah, they don't have the zero hanging over them, but I tell you what, they're still, you know, they're making improvements. But they need to make them a little bit faster this season. I think if they want to contend a little bit more. It's been a rough start for them. You know, looking at the defense side of things, you know, they're only on offense, they're only averaging 13 points a game, but they're allowing over 44 points a game. And I tell you what, in high school football, I don't care, pros or in college, you're giving up 44 and only scoring 13. That makes for a long day at the ballpark.
Yeah, out of their six opponents on the season, five of them have been over 40 points on the year. The Northwestern last week was the only one that hasn't. They scored 13. But they played some tough opponents, too. I mean, they lost to Bell Fountain, Jonathan Alder, who we know is good, Bluffton, West Liberty Salem, who's 6-0, and then their other loss was to the Lehman Cavaliers, who were 4-2. So how about Coach Jenny in his first season here? We talked back in week number 2 and we saw the West Liberty Salem Tigers over here. It's a full rebuild for this team. And as we head into week 7, we're expecting a little bit, you know, more in week 7 than we saw in week 2.
Yeah, as you look at it, you know, you're looking for some more progression coming out of his team. Obviously, you know, back earlier in the week, and, you know, Hunter Andricks, you know, is throwing for 464 yards. He's really only going about 43% completion rate out there. 4 TDs, but really, you can tell where he's kind of inexperienced and kind of getting new out there and taking over as the quarterback program, because he's thrown 7 interceptions this year. I mean, you look at it as a whole, you know, you're only looking at, you know, week 7, so, you know, an average and 1 a game, and those are some mistakes he can't have as a young quarterback out there, especially when he's trying to rebuild the defense and actually the whole team as a whole out there. That's just mistakes that he cannot be having out there right now.
And they've also been playing another guy QB the last few weeks. He's got a little bit of time. That's Sully Hughes. He's a freshman. He's come in and did well, including throwing a touchdown pass last week at Northwestern. We expect to see him on the field some tonight.
Yeah, we expect to see him out there on the field tonight. And he really kind of had his coming out party last week, as you know, he kind of made an air raid offense. You know, he's a 9-for-11 last week and threw for 150 yards almost. So here we are. He got one game, and he's already got a third almost of what Andricks has the whole entire season. So we expect to see him a little bit out tonight. Now, we do admit the team is bounced, so that's something Coach Jenny does pretty well with the Benjamin Logan Raiders. He does have a bounced rushing attack out there versus a pass attack, but he's got 566 yards on the year and 6 TDs. Colin Powell leads the receiving with 143 yards, and the defense, where they really set that last week and created some pressures, they got 3 sacks against Northwestern, so they'll look to try to build off of that tonight as well.
Yeah, they got to slow down a pretty fast team, and that's the Indian Lake Lakers, who have been, you know, pretty impressive here this year. They're 4-2. They sit 12th in their region, by the way, in the playoff points. I mean, they actually dropped a slot last week, even though they won. What the Lakers need are some of these teams they beat to win.
Yes.
They need some secondary points from Fairbanks, Allen East, Tecumseh, Graham. Those teams, if they can win some games, then that'll help them out. But anyway, How about this 4-2 Lakers squad? What do you think of them?
Yeah, so the 4-2 Lakers, you know, we've covered them quite a bit this season, so they've had some really good games. And, you know, again, we talked about it before, I'm going to reiterate it again, is I think this is a Laker team that's farther along than what one would anticipate coming into this season. You know, coming off the, you know, a 1-9 record last year to coming in already 4-2 for this year is a pretty good turnaround there for Coach Rapp and his team this year. But I think it's really going to hinge on, and we said it a lot last week, it's going to hinge on Burke Lillard. Mm-hmm. And Burke Lillard really does run the show on this offense. He's completing at a really good rate of 62% passing. 953 yards. He's third in the CBC, 12 touchdowns, which is really key for him. He's only thrown three interceptions, but he's also rushed for 550 yards as well and put in six TDs as well. So we talked about last week, the offense starts and ends with Burke Lillard.
Yeah, and he had five more touchdowns last week. We saw him run for a 51-yarder. He threw for three, and then he returned a punt.
Yeah.
Seven whole yards for a touchdown in what was a weird play in that third quarter. Last week, we were there last week at Graham to see the Lakers. Little bit of a slow start. It was 7-7 at halftime, 27-0 in the second half. Coach Rapp said in the pregame show, we want to see the second half Laker team out here this week than the first half.
Yeah, you don't want to come out flat too often as you're coming out here as for any football team, no matter if it's any like Lakers, Benjamin Logan, matter of fact, too, does not want to come out flat tonight. They want to come out scoring, they want to come out hot, and they want to come out putting some points on the board and do not want to have a flat starting out and have to play from behind tonight.
And for Indian Lake as well, a guy who's come on. He was pretty quiet last week, though, but we like him. It's Quest Clay.
Yeah, Quest Clay, you know, pretty quiet last week, but you know, he's got almost 400 yards and 8 TDs on the year. He is definitely the go-to every man guy. So he's a starting wide receiver. He's a starting cornerback. And he's also their punt returner and kick returner. So he plays all those positions for the Indian Lake Lakers. So he is gets his hand on the ball quite a bit for the Lakers.
John Rapp comes in here. His team is 4-2, looking to move to 5-2 on the season. Your coach Jenny, you're trying to get your second win of the year. Let's go inside the Indian Lake locker room right now. What are you saying if you're Coach Rapp?
Yeah, for Coach Rapp, I need to see some defensive pressure. So I think the Indian Lake one, where they need to prove this year, is they've only recorded 2 sacks all season long.
Yeah.
And so that offensive line or defensive line really needs to take control and put some pressure on the front of the Benjamin Logan Raiders. And I want to see them get in the backfield and make these young quarterbacks flustered for the Benjamin Logan Raiders. If I'm Coach Rapp, I think that's one message I'm definitely stringing into my team there before we take the field.
How about if you're Coach Jenny, you're actually some of your team's out here on the field right now during homecoming festivities, but what are you saying to your squad as they get ready to take the field?
Yeah, so, you know, I'm out to my squad, and I said, hey, guys, we're coming off our first win. We got the monkey off our back. You know, we were 0-4 until last week, and now we actually got it done. We got that W. We know how to finish out a game. We know how to make them the defensive stands when we need to make them. So let's just play a very good, our pace of game, no turnovers, and let's just be a solid football team out there tonight and try to get away with a W. If they have some turnovers tonight or they start off maybe too slow, I can look for the Lakers to really pounce on them and try to take an early lead.
Yeah, you're right there. Ben Logan's got to stay close. I mean, they get down by like 2 scores here early. It's going to be really hard for them to come back out here. By the way, as we look at the series here for Benjamin Logan and Indian Lake over the last decade, Indian Lake actually won 10 straight until last year. Benjamin Logan snapped that 10-game winning streak for the Lakers last year when they went over to Indian Lake and put it on the Lakers pretty good over there at Indian Lake High School. So, you know, Benjamin Logan looking for their second consecutive in the series. Indian Lake looking to take back control of the series here tonight.
Yeah, if you're the Lakers, you know, you hear the term out there. Sometimes when the football program starts a new season, you know, revenge tour. Mm-hmm. You know, and this is a game I think Coach Rapp got circled. Because, I mean, they really got taken to the, you know, cleaners last year during this game.
They did.
And it's not, you know, some of them players graduated, but both these teams, about 90% of that team, you know, is, for the Lakers anyway, is still on the field. So they remember, you know, the feeling of that game, and they don't want to relive it, that's for sure. They want to deliver it tonight.
I think we might get started late out here tonight because they haven't done the national anthem yet.
Right.
And we're 2 minutes till 7. Things are a little bit behind because of long homecoming festivities. So,
yeah, extra long. I mean, it's cool they're doing it, definitely, but definitely some long homecoming festivities. But it looks like we might be able to do the national anthem here pretty soon.
Yes. So we're going to pause for the national anthem here, and you'll be able to listen to it on WPKO and watch it here on PeakofOhioTV.com. the national anthem here on 98.3 WPKO and PeakofOhioTV.com. All right, teams are going to be taking the field out here as we get ready for that. Rick, let's take a look at a few other games going on tonight over on the drive. Bell Fountain's down at Tecumseh to play the Arrows tonight. Boy, I tell you what, the Chiefs need a bounce back week, don't they?
Yeah, I tell you what, the Chiefs need a bounce back week because it doesn't get any easier for them the rest of the year. They got some tough ones ahead of them. So after, you know, I guess that performance you can say they put up last week or tried to muster out there anyway.
Yeah.
They definitely need to come out against Tecumseh firing all cylinders and get back in the win column because, like I said, it doesn't get any easier for them the rest of the year.
How about our game on the bowl tonight? West Liberty-Salem at 6-0. At 6-0, West Jefferson and the Rough Riders.
I tell you what, I mean, that could be the deciding factor, part of that conference over there in that area. So, again, I've been riding West Liberty all year. I think they're a solid football team. I guess I'm, you know, bipartisan. I haven't seen the Rough Riders at all, but I look for West Liberty-Salem to come out there with the victory. Just my prediction out there. But I think it's going to be a good game down there on the bowl. But, hey, keep tuning in to this backyard rivalry. I think there's going to be some fireworks coming out here tonight for this game.
Indian Lake getting ready to take the field. Looking at some other games elsewhere, Riverside is over at Lehman tonight. Big game in the TRC. Mechanicsburg's taking on Fairbanks. Triad is down on the road at Northeastern. Waynesfield-Goshen hosting 6-0 Elgin. Both those teams 6-0. We'll watch that game tonight as well and all the other games on the rolling scoreboard at peakofohio.com. The Lakers are out now as well as the Raiders are ready to take the field for the backyard brawl. And by the way, tonight's coin toss brought to you by Elevate Chiropractic. Take control of your health with Elevate Chiropractic Clinic there in Bell Fountain. Visit ElevateChiroCare.com. Toss was won by Benjamin Logan, and they are electing to receive. I think a good decision by Coach Jenny. Get the football. Try to establish yourself early and keep that Indian Lake offense off the field.
Yeah, I mean, that's exactly what they're going to do. I think they're going to, again, we saw them, week two, and they're not a high-flying offense. They are a slower-paced, more methodical offense out there. So, hey, drain the clock and keep the Lakers off there. I mean, that's the name of the game here. You score more points and the clock runs zero, you win.
Kendall Pleichert and Colin Powell drop back deep to receive the kick for the Benjamin Logan Raiders. Indian Lake Lakers, for our radio audience, are kicking off left to right here as we view the home side of the stadium. Kickoff is brought to you by Dairy Queen of Bell Fountain, and we're going to get started about 3 minutes late, but that's okay as we get things rolling out here at Benjamin Logan High School for week number 7 in high school football. Tee it up at the 40-yard line, and it's in the air. Good kick that Pleichert will pull in at the 8-yard line, middle of the football field, 15, 20, 25, still on his feet, 30, 35, and out near the 36-yard line for a solid return. And Benjamin Logan has good field position here to start the ball game.
Yeah, nice return back there. And, again, I'm interested to see who is the starting quarterback for the Benjamin Logan Raiders.
It's going to be Hunter Andrix here at the beginning.
So?
Yeah, 17's in there right now.
Oh, so. Yeah, there he is.
First and 10 at the 37. Andrix coming in. And he will run the show here. Hunter is a junior, 5'8", 155-pound quarterback. And he'll get the work here on first and 10. Couple wideout split right. Oh, two men in motion at the same time come across, and they will set. And they will hand off on first down. Hassel spins forward, maybe a yard for Alex Hassel, number 4, the freshman running back.
Yeah, we talked about Andrix earlier. You know, he is a junior, but, you know, they had the same quarterback out here at Benjamin Logan for a long time. So even though he's a junior, he did not get any starting playing time. So this is his first year at the helm.
Yes. Second down and 9 for the Raiders. Ball at their own 38-yard line. Andrix has trips to his left. And he splits a man out there, too. They're going to run a quick screen to Hassel. He's got it. 35-yard line. Makes a move at the 40 with a penalty flag. As he gets out to the 44, looks like somebody has a little bit of extracurriculars down there on the offensive side of things when it comes to either an illegal block or hold.
Yeah, it looks like I think they're going to call a holding call, but I would call a legal block in the back on that one. But
and back him up 10 yards from pretty much the line of scrimmage, so it's going to set up a second down and 19. And pretty much, Benjamin Logan's offense, you know, it's not designed for second and 15, 18, 20. It's not designed for first and 15. I mean, it's really three yards, you know, in a cloud of dust, so to speak. They like to grind it out.
Yes, that is correct. I think an interesting stat tonight, they actually got Brooke Lillard starting as free safety. The last couple games, he has not played out there.
Man in motion. Andrix will play action. Rolling to his right to throw. Fires out. Has a man out of the backfield. Complete. And just a small gain out to the 30-yard line. Setting up a third and very long here for Benjamin Logan. As the catch is made by Michael Dilbone.
Yeah, nice catch there out the backfield, but little to no gain on that one. And nice tackle by Madden Lillard there coming in there from the cornerback position and bringing him down. So, you know, again, you just talked about it a second ago, Chad. They're not made to go big passes down the field. Mm-hmm. You know, they're deep in their own territory right now. And maybe Coach Jennings just say, hey, maybe call a little counterplay, get out of here and punt it and live to fight another day.
Third and 17 from their own 30-yard line. Empty backfield. Andrix in the gun, will roll to his right to throw, looking for a quick hitter, fires out and skips it into the dirt as he's pressured, incomplete, and it's a three and out for the Benjamin Logan Raiders as the penalty really, really hurt him.
Yeah, that was a drive stopper on this play, that's for sure. I mean, they had a couple yards getting some there, and then that holding penalty just definitely just is not something that the Raiders want to have because they're still trying to figure their way through their offense.
West Clay will drop back deep to receive. The punter would probably be wise to try to keep it away from him. He is fast. Is he standing at his own 36-yard line? Low snap.
Oh,
it's loose,
him.
And here comes the Lakers, and they plow him over at the 10. Ball's loose on the ground. And Indy Lake picks it up and goes in for a touchdown. Oh, my goodness. Brody Reisinger cleans up the loose change, and it's 6-0 Indy Lake.
I tell you what, that's twice in back-to-back weeks. Again, it's been muffed every time, but the Indian Lake Lakers special teams has cleaned it up there and took it into the end zone there for a touchdown for Indian Lake Lakers. Couldn't ask for a worse start for the Benjamin Logan Raiders.
Wow, low snap, and it squirts through the punter's legs, and then he got lit up, man.
Yeah, he did.
Two guys came in and just plowed him. Ball's loose. Reisinger picks it up, and it's 6-0 just like that. And the extra point from Colton Cummins is coming up. Brought to you by Fissile Floor Covering. Here comes the snap. Good one. Hold is good, and the kick is up, and it is no good. Wide to the right. So 10 minutes exactly to go in the first quarter. Indian Lake leads in our Quest Federal Credit Union High School football scoreboard 6-0. Let's take a break. We'll come back with more right after this on 98.3 WPKO and PeakofOhioTV.com.
At Easton Water, we're fully committed to fulfilling our promises to our customers. As a locally owned, staffed, and operated company, our reputation is critical, and we mean what we say. We want to be your trusted source for everything water. If recent changes in the market have left you high and dry when it comes to drinking water, water softeners, salt, or anything else to do with the water in your home or business, we're here for you and would love to be your trusted water partner. Visit eastonwater.com or give us a call, and we'll get you added to our route.
Donato's Pizza's open late tonight. Order online and pick it up after the game. Go to Donato's.com. Sign up for Donato's Rewards and turn it into free rewards with free food. Donato's, every piece is important. South Main Bell Fountain and online at Donato's.com.
Welcome back to Benjamin Logan. Lakers up 6-0 here. Kickoff brought to you by Dairy Queen of Bell Fountain. Here's the kick, and the Raiders field at the 18-yard line. Here they come back into the field at the 25 and dropped right there. Is Colin Powell, and that's where the Raiders will set up now. First down and 10, down 6-0. And you said it, Rick, not the greatest start for the Benjamin Logan special teams there, who already found themselves in a hole 6-0. Now I think their offense, they at least got to grind out some first downs here.
Yeah, they need to put a nice methodical drive through and keep, you know, they do not want to go quick three and out. That's the last thing you want to do after coming back from that you know, that mishap right there, and they definitely need to keep their offense on the field.
So first and 10, Hunter Hendrix is your quarterback here for the Raiders. Ball's at their own 26. They send a man in motion. Now they bring another one back into the backfield. And they're going to fake it, keep it with Hendrix. Hendrix off to the left side, and he's going to go forward for a couple on first down. As the Lakers take him down there, Noah Shirk with the tackle. Second and 7.
Yeah, that's just something I think if you're Coach Rapp, too, based off last week, you want to clean up your tackling a little bit. You know, last week you had a lot of broken tackles there against Graham early in the first half. And right now you can see it right now. They're making the one touch, and then they're bringing the Benjamin Logan Raiders right down to the ground.
Jordan Pinder in the backfield along with Andrix in the shotgun. Second down and 7. Man in motion is Dilbone to the left side of the line. And what we got here, a false start's got to be whistled on Benjamin Logan. Boy, they cannot play behind the sticks. That's going to make it a second and 12. So So a procedure penalty on the Raiders. Second down and 12.
It looked like he might have, I think when they went to send the man in motion, the wide receiver, the wide out and the tailback wanted to go at the same time. So I think that's what they called a false start on the wide receiver.
Okay. Clock at 9 minutes to go in the first quarter. Indian Lake leads 6-0. There's Dillbone setting to that left side of the line now on second and 12. Andricks to throw. Nope, he's going to keep a quarterback keeper up the middle. Gets by a couple of guys, and then he's stuffed right back near the original line of scrimmage. So third and 10 coming up.
I tell you what, Lakers are definitely pinning their ears back right now and just coming after Andricks in that backfield, making it, he's not getting him any time back there.
Ryan Culp, one of the Lakers in on that tackle, amongst three guys in on that. Third down and a long 9 coming up here for the Raiders. As they need to get to the 36 for a first down. Trips to the left, 2 wides to the right, 5 wides in this set. Look out for some pressure now. Andricks to throw, good pocket. Fires in the middle of the football field. He's just throwing it up for grabs, and it's picked off. Picked off by Burke Lillard. Burke returning to the left side of the field, breaks a tackle with the 45. He's at the 50. He's inside Raider territory down near the 41-yard line where Indian Lake will set up first and 10 on what was an easy pick for Burke.
Yeah, I mean, he just threw that one right up in center field, and Burke Lillard just come back there saying, hey, fair catch, coach, I'll take this one. And he took that one to the house, or not take it to the house, but took it back about 20 yards there for the return. And just an ill-advised throw there by Andricks. I mean, he was just trying to, I guess I'm not sure, I would say making something out of something, but there was nothing there to make anything out of. So
yeah, there were at least 3 Lakers back there.
Yeah, I mean, he threw it right into their territory.
First and 10 Lakers already up 6-0 at the Raiders 41. And the offense takes their first snap. It's a counterplay to the Cosby. Takes it down to the 36-yard line as he's going to pick up 5 yards, second and 5.
I will say one thing out here. I tell you what, man, it's homecoming night here at Benjamin Logan, but, man, these stands are jam-packed. I mean, they're packed on the track, on the stands.
Yeah.
And you can tell it's a crosstown rivalry because even the Lakers stadium, their side of the fans, the away side, they're jam-packed too.
Second down and 5. Lakers going to pass. Quick hitter out, complete. And drop down at the 30-yard line is Quest Clay for a first and 10.
I think if you're Coach Rapp, you want to see maybe Burke Lillard settle down a little bit. You know, he was a little bit errant throws last week, a little bit high ones, a little bit low ones. So see him come out and make some nice time throws, I think will give Coach Rapp a good feeling coming into mostly this game.
First and 10 at the Raiders 30. Lillard to throw again, looking left, pump fakes. Now he's going to go for a bomb down the left side. And, oh, what a catch by Clay inside the 5, down to the 4-yard line. He went between 2 Raiders and comes down with it.
I'll tell you what, we're here on Peak of Ohio TV tonight. I encourage you to watch that replay of that one because that was an excellent catch by Quest Clay. And I tell you what, he's really making a name for himself. Brings you down in the red zone here, and the red zone's brought to you by Advanced Pools of Ohio, your full-service swimming pool professionals.
First and 10 for the Lakers down to the 4-yard line, and the Cos to the left side. Cosby fights forward, and he's in for a touchdown from 4 yards out, and the Lakers have themselves a 2-score lead. And we're not even midway through the first quarter.
Yeah, and brings up another PAT for Indian Lake Lakers, and that PAT is brought to you by Fissel's Floor Covering, covering a reputation you can stand on.
12-0 here. Let's see. They're going to kick one here. So Cummins will come back in for the PAT. And here comes the snap. A little high. Good hold. Kick is up, and it is good this time around. 6:57 to go in the opening quarter. Indian Lake's out fast, 13-0 in our Quest Federal Credit Union High School football scoreboard. Let's take a break from Benjamin Logan. More coming up after this on 98.3 WPKO and peakofohiotv.com.
Looking for a hobby that brings out your creativity? Crockpot Studio offers many classes to help you. From beginner's pottery to advanced, there's sure to be a class you'll love. Learn to create your own masterpieces from a chunk of clay to something beautiful. For openings, check out their Facebook page. On Wednesdays from noon till 8 and select Sundays, there's Paint Your Own. Just purchase a ceramic piece there and paint. Lots to choose from for your home or for gifts. Have fun, relax, meet new people, and be creative at Crackpot Studio.
At Bell Fountain's Best Car Wash, we take care of your vehicle 100%, from the first drop of hot, clean water to the last stroke of our super soft, shine-enhancing towel. And you can choose from four levels of clean, basic, plus, premium, and ultimate, starting at just $8. Bell Fountain's Best Car Wash, 720 South Main.
Kickoff brought to you by Dairy Queen of Bell Fountain. Bleicher to let it bounce, and it will go into the end zone for a touchback. So it'll be at the 20-yard line for Benjamin Logan. 13-0, Indian Lake leads here. 6:57 to go here in the first quarter of play. And Indian Lake's off to a fast start, just what Coach Rapp wanted.
Yeah, I mean, he preaching fast start. He wanted that team that showed up there in the second half against Graham to come out here in the first quarter tonight and really put it to the Benjamin Logan. I tell you what, I mean, they played solid, they played nice, but Benjamin Logan's not helping themselves with the penalties and the miscue on the punt and on the turnover there for the interception.
All right, here we see the freshman coming in, Solly Hughes, number 6, will be at quarterback. The freshman, 6 foot, 150 pounds. He's in on this series. As he's got a wideout split left on first down, he will read option, hands it off. And the running back through is Hassel. Goes forward for almost 3 yards.
A nice little run up the middle there, and it'd be interesting to see if they let him air it out a little bit. Hughes for the Benjamin Logan Raiders, because like I said last week, 9 of 11 for almost 150 yards and a touchdown. So,
yeah, he's been able to impress, that's for sure. And as a freshman, by the way, he's just a freshman, and he's already 6 foot. So,
yeah.
I mean, I think he's got a little more growing probably left in him. Second down for the Raiders. Hughes wants to throw, rolling to his right. Right-handed thrower going down the left sideline and is up for grabs, and it's picked off. And this time it's Burke Lillard returning back inside the 50-yard line, and it's going to go again back over to the Indian Lake Lakers on the second pick of the night. Burke Lillard, first and 10 at the Benjamin Logan 47-yard line.
Ooh.
Threw in the double coverage that
time. Both ill-advised throws there for both quarterbacks. That's the second pick for Burke Lillard tonight. He's just sitting back there free safety and just catching that one.
So Benjamin Logan will turn it over on downs again. Matter of fact, we have not been on the other side of the 50.
No.
The entire first quarter here. 6:11 to go in the first, and here comes Indian Lake. And they're looking for some knockout punches here early.
Yeah, they put another touchdown on the board. It's it is tough sledding for the Lakers.
Couple wideout split left. Burke back to work on first and 10, looking, plenty of time. Rolling to his right, the throw, looking, fires down the right sideline, and it's out of bounds, intended for his brother, Madden Lillard. And we got a penalty flag on a hold for the Lakers. That will back them up into their territory.
Yeah, I mean, Lillard had all day long to throw that ball, but generally when you get that much time, there's probably going to be a hold happening in the backfield.
Looking at some other scores, Jonathan Alder and London tied at 7 in the first quarter. That's a monster game in the Kenton Trail. North Union is leading Northwestern 7-0, and West Liberty Salem and West Jeff are tied up 7-7 on the bowl. Boy, there's some big games tonight. And North Union, by the way, they are 1-5, but they got to be like one of the best 1-5 teams you're ever going to find.
Yes.
Lillard rolling to his left, looking to throw, fires out, has his man out there, Quest Clay, across the 50 again, and he's going to get back to about the original line of scrimmage. So he's going to pick up nearly 10 yards and make it a second down and 10.
That's one thing that's improved by the Lakers' offense over last year to this year. And as season's going, they're able now to start, getting them 8 to 10 yard plays when they need to if they get behind the sticks, to where Benjamin Logan is just not there yet.
Yeah. Second and 10 at the Raider 47-yard line. And they're going to throw. Burke rolling to his right. Lillard looking down. Has a man wide open. Madden Lillard got it. First down and out of bounds at the 32. That's pitch and catch.
Yeah, that's too easy. That was about a 10, 12, about a 14-yard completion there. And so they picked up, about 24 yards right there.
In two plays.
Yeah, in two plays. So
Lakers are back to work fast as well, as they have first and 10 at the Raider 32. Play clock at 25. They're ready to snap it. Two wideout split left. It's a handoff. Cosby up in a big hole. Cosby, 25, makes a move. 20, and down at the 16-yard line. Cosby with a big run.
I'll tell you what, man, he is just coming on strong. I mean, these players right now, they're feeling it as the season carries on. And I tell you what, Indian Lake just entered the red zone again, and that's brought to you by Advanced Pools of Ohio, your full-service swimming pool professionals.
First and 10. Indian Lake on the march, already up 13-0. There's a handoff to Cosby. Cosby gets hit in the line, and he is hit backwards. A couple of Raiders in there on that tackle that time, including big number 74, Hunter Peterson. Picks up a yard, second and 9. Urbana on top of Kenton Ridge right now, 14-0 already first quarter. Hill Climbers need that win. They're 5-1, but they're 18th in their region in points.
Yeah.
Outside looking in. Fake the handoff. Burke keeps it himself, 10. Burke inside near the 7 or 6. So it'll be a third and short coming up here for the Lakers on the Burke Lillard keeper.
Kind of in the Burke Lillard show right about now. I mean, through the nice passes he's had there to Quest Clay with two interceptions on the night already. And I tell you what, we talked about earlier that this football team does run through Burke Lillard.
Going to be a third down and 2 coming up from the 7-yard line. And they go with a couple wideouts split right. Clay's in the slot. Now they move him in motion. They will give it to him on a jet sweep. Quest Clay getting to the outside, and it's all a race to the end zone, and he's going to win that race for a touchdown. Nice block on the outside there to springing free. Quest Clay goes in 7 yards out, and the Lakers have their third score of the first quarter. They're up 19-0.
It brings up just another PAT, and it's brought to you by Thistle's Floor Covering, covering a reputation you can stand on. I tell you what, I mean, he's just fast. Yeah. And then it's going to take, you know, when he gets that jet sweep and he's already in motion getting that head start, you're going to be quick on your feet if you're Benjamin Logan to stop him to the corner.
Cummins with the extra point here. Third one of the first quarter. Good snap and hold. The kick is up. And the officials say good. 3:46 to go in the first quarter of play. 20-0. Indian Lake is pouring it on. We'll take a break from Benjamin Logan High School. More high school football coming up after this on 98.3 WPKO and PeakofOhioTV.com.
Liberty Gathering Place in downtown West Liberty serves breakfast all day, every day. They have homemade desserts, made from scratch noodles, and the salad bar is open Wednesday through Sunday. But on Fridays, they are serving up all-you-can-eat fish. Yes, that's right. It's all-you-can-eat fish on Fridays. Enjoy golden fried fish with your choice of two sides, and maybe finish it off with one of their homemade desserts. Don't miss the all-you-can-eat fish every Friday at the Liberty Gathering Place, open until 7.
Comer Insurance Agency in DeGraff offers insurance coverage for home, life, auto, commercial, and farm. Visit their website at comerinsuranceagency.com for their number and more information. Comer Insurance Agency, specializing in helping you with the right coverage.
Indian Lake scores again. 20-0 they lead on the Quest Federal Credit Union scoreboard. And they'll kick off again, brought to you by Dairy Queen of Bell Fountain. Another good kick. Plykert at the 7-yard line, 12-yard line. Good return out across the 30 and down near the 35 and out to the 37. Goes Kendall Plykert. So Benjamin Logan's actually had some pretty good starting field position. They've been out across the 30 a couple of times, but the offense is sputtering right now. Let's see who they go with the quarterback here.
Yeah, I think Paul Jenny's maybe trying to figure out himself. Yeah. Who do I need to go with here?
And it's going to be Hughes, the freshman. And at this point, I mean, you know, at 1-5, you're down 20-0 in this game. Maybe it's the freshman show from here on out.
Yeah.
You know? Couple guys move in motion to the right side of the line. First and 10 for the Raiders. Hughes will hand off. Running back trying to get free, and he will be tackled for a loss on the play. That's number 27, Jordan Pinder. And he's going to lose a couple of yards. So second and long here for the Raiders. Well, it's tough, too. I mean, you don't have confidence in your passing game right now. You're throwing two picks.
Yeah.
But then the running game's got to step up, and they haven't been able to get anything chewing on the ground right now either.
They did make some holes up front for Benjamin Logan.
Hughes.
Oh, fumble.
Loose ball on the ground. Indian Lake's got it. Third turnover of the quarter. Indian Lake's going to be setting up shop at the Benjamin Logan 31. Hughes thought the running back had it. The running back must have thought that Hughes was going to tuck it and keep it himself. And, oh, my goodness, the wheels are falling off here for Benjamin Logan in the first quarter of play, as we still got 3 minutes to go, and the Lakers are staring at a fourth touchdown.
I mean, how? Go back to the beginning of this game, and if you're Coach Ginny, you're like, hey, Coach Ginny, your first four possessions or three possessions, you're going to start on about your 35 to 36 yard line every time. Yeah. He's like, I'll take that.
Yes.
But you don't want to take this result.
No. It's been a tough sled for the Raiders here.
That's first a turnover on every possession. Well, I guess, he had the punt or whatever, but you
right.
still.
Well, blocked.
Yeah, it's still blocked. Yeah. Yeah, so.
First and 10, Lakers looking for more at the 31. Lillard going deep down the left sideline. Got a man out
got
there.
Him.
Touchdown, Indian Lake. 31 yards out. That's Brody Risinger with his second touchdown of the night. And just a beautiful throw from Lillard. He dropped it right over the defender.
Yeah, I mean, that was a over-shoulder drop-in right there. And I tell you what, you couldn't ask for a better throw from Lillard on that one. Just dropped it right in the bucket and puts him in the end zone again. So I tell you what, man, this Laker team is firing on all cylinders. Brings up a PAT brought to you by Fistles Floor Covering.
Man, extra point is up, and it's good. We still got 2:53 to play in the first quarter of play. Indian Lakes put up 27 points. They're up 27-0 on the Quest Federal Credit Union scoreboard. We'll take a break. More after this on 98.3 WPKO and PeakofOhioTV.com.
Are you looking for a place to tan or do your laundry? Buckeye Wash and Tan has you covered. Their goal is to provide you the highest level service and products in a clean and friendly environment at an affordable price. Their laundry facility is fast, reliable, and saves you time. Full service will take care of the laundry for you. There's always an attendant on duty. Ohio weather can be dreary at times. Getting a tan helps you feel good all year long, regardless of the weather. They provide clean and well-maintained beds to help you feel your best. Let Buckeye Wash and Tan brighten your clothes and your day.
Have you tried this month's Blizzard of the Month at the Dairy Queen of Urbana? It's the Caramel Fudge Cheesecake. You'll find cheesecake pieces and salted caramel pieces covered in fudge. Try one today at the Dairy Queen of Urbana.
Welcome back to Benjamin Logan. Indian Lake up 27-0 here as they kick off again, brought to you by Dairy Queen of Bellefontaine. Plikert at the 12, 15, 20-yard line, middle of the football field, 25, and up right there at the 27. And here comes the Raider offense again. And, boy, Rick, we've had a muffed punt, two interceptions, and a fumble to start the game for the Raiders. Here comes the freshman quarterback. And, well, I mean, this is going to be it right here. When you're a freshman and you come in and start on a rebuild, you're going to be taking some licks, and that's what Hughes is going to be taking now. I think maybe we see him the rest of the night.
Yeah, I think you're more now. You're a coach, but now you're really coaching a young player. Mm-hmm. You know, he's going to make some errors. He's going to make some mistakes, and now you just got to keep his confidence there.
First and 10 at their own 29-yard line. Pitch play out on first down, and nice play here across the 35 out to the 37-yard line. Alex Hassel. Second down and 2. Raiders trying to get that first down of the game here. 2:30 to go in the opening quarter.
That's got to be one of Benjamin Logan's biggest gain of the night there. 8 yards there.
It is. It is. So second and short. And when you got second and short, I mean, it just opens up so much of the playbook, too, for you.
Yeah. No procedure penalties. They do not want to see them on this drive.
Yeah, you can't get a penalty here. Second and 2. Dillbone in motion, and they're going to pass. Hughes looking to throw. Fires in the middle of the field. Got a man wide open. Caught. Powell's got it. He's across midfield and stumbles down and tackled at the Laker 47-yard line. Boy, he slung that one.
Yeah, he's got a little arm on him, a little cannon there, and he slung that one right up there to the middle of the field. Tell you what, he had two wide receivers open, so it was really just his choice where he wanted to go with that one. So, hey, man, you got to tell you what, they made it on the plus side of the 50 now.
Raiders with their first down of the game and the first time they've been on the other side of the 50 in the entire first quarter of play. First and 10. Hughes going to throw again, rolling to his left, slings it out there, has a man, got it, Powell again, makes a move at the 40. Powell down at the 36-yard line. He's going to have another first down as he gets 11 yards.
Yeah, I tell you what, Holbrook has a nice tight spiral on that ball. I can see him release it a little bit. Not so much side army, yeah. But a little bit more higher up in his throwing motion, but he's whipping it out there.
So they're on the march down to the Laker 36. 1:18 to go in the opening quarter. Hughes with a couple straight completions here. There's a couple guys to the right side of this formation. Two wideouts split to the left. He's going to throw it again, looking to his right. And now he comes in the middle for a screen. Dillbone's got it. Dillbone at the 30, 25, down the left sideline. Stumbles with a shoestring tackle inside the 20, down to the 17-yard line. Michael Dillbone with the catch and a good-looking screen for the Raiders.
Yeah, that's a nice little screenplay there for the Benjamin Logan Raiders. And I tell you what, man, their offense, as much as the trouble they had during the whole entire, pretty much the first quarter, ended on turnover or something every time they had the ball, they're on the move this one and getting some nice confidence there for Holbrook.
First and 10 at the 17 in the red zone for the first time tonight of the Raiders. And they're going to run this time up the middle, and not much there. Yard or two for Alex Hassel.
Yep, and the Raiders enter the red zone, and that's brought to you by Advanced Pools of Ohio, your full-service swimming pool professionals.
Two-yard gain to the 15. Second down and eight, but Benjamin Logan putting together a nice-looking drive here now. Now they need to cash in.
Yes.
Two wideout split left. Now they move Dillbone to the left side of that line, too. Second and eight. Pitch play. Hassel getting wide. Hassel 15 and to the 14-yard line for a gain of one.
I tell you what, the Lakers came to hit tonight. I mean, they are making some sure tackles, and they are connecting.
Into the first quarter out here at Benjamin Logan High School. Indian Lake with a huge first quarter. They lead it 27-0 in our Quest Federal Credit Union High School football scoreboard. We'll be back with more after this on 98.3 WPKO and PeakofOhioTV.com.
Hi, everybody. This is Dr. Jacob from Elevate Chiropractic, Bell Fountain's newest chiropractic clinic. Aren't you tired of being in pain and not living life to your fullest? Chiropractic care not only relieves pain, but more importantly, it helps your body handle stress better in the long term. We tailor every adjustment specific to you with the help of our in-house digital x-ray suite, along with corrective stretches and exercises. It's time to take back control of your own health today. Visit ElevateChiroCare.com or call 937-210-5525 to schedule now.
Thinking about cleaning up your property or home? Call Bobcat Multiworks for a dumpster. They offer 10 and 20 cubic foot sizes. They deliver them right to your door and pick them back up. It's the perfect way to dispose of all the things you don't need anymore. Check them out at BobcatMultiworks.com.
Attention Fat Boys Pizza and Ice Cream customers, it's that time again, it's football time. Get your Fat Boys fix before the game, or order while the game's going on. We're open till 10, we have hot pizzas, subs, and salads. 592 FATS.
Are you penalized because your bank's head coach is located out of town? At the People Savings Bank, our head coach is right here in your hometown to help you meet your goals. Come score a touchdown with the People Savings Bank. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Start of the second quarter out here, and referees are going to blow the play dead and call a timeout. Benjamin Logan's got to burn a timeout before we even start the second quarter of play. So, all right, we'll take a quick timeout as well, as we'll return to Benjamin Logan after this on 98.3 WPKO and PeakofOhioTV.com.
Come to the pizza shop where all the locals know where to go. Jack and Doe's, a family tradition for over 50 years. Started by the Valentine family in the late 60s, it's now operated by the third generation. They were taught how to make delicious, quality pizza, subs, chicken, and more. Jack and Doe's, home of the original large sheet pizza. Visit their Facebook page or one of their three locations for dine-in, delivery, or carryout in Kenton, Russell's Point, or Urbana. Jack and Doe's, the tradition lives on.
Welcome back. First play of the second quarter, Benjamin Logan, third and six. And they will hand off up the middle. Hassel's going to go to the 10 and be stood up at the 10-yard line. He's going to be a couple yards short of a first down. Fourth down and two coming up for Benjamin Logan. Coach Jenny will go for it here. They need 2 yards for a first down.
This is a big one right here. You definitely, after this drive, you need, I mean, for a morale booster, you want to cash in.
Yes, for the morale booster, that's a good statement right there. Fourth and two at the 10. Hughes will hand off. Hassel hit in the backfield, and he'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. It's going to be a turnover on downs at the 10-yard line. So the Raiders put together a nice drive, but it stalls at the 10 on a turnover on downs. And Indian Lake takes over with 11:22 to go in the half here, already leading 27-0 on our Quest Federal Credit Union scoreboard.
Okay. Maybe I'm a morale booster for the Lakers instead of going for Benjamin Logan. Because Benjamin Logan just drove down that whole, basically the length of the field, you know, about, 75 yards almost, and they couldn't cash in, and the Lakes puts them up on a goal line stand. Well, pretty close to goal line stand.
I got a big update coming up here as soon as we get a moment. I'll let you know what's going on, but it's a very big update. Rolling the pass on first down. Lillard gets it out to Quest Clay. Quest out of bounds across the 20-yard line around the 22. And that's going to be a first down. All right, update. Riverside is up on Lehman 7-0 into the first quarter. However, in the second quarter as they get started, Miles Platfoot is being carted off the field with a leg injury.
Oh.
So that is huge for Riverside. Their starting quarterback, their four-year starter, and it does not look good when you get carted off.
No, it does not.
And boy, do they have, they're 5-1, and man. Quarterback keeper on first and 10. Lillard squirts through the hole and gets out to the 30-yard line where he's going to pick up 7 yards and a late penalty flag coming from the referee in the back. Personal foul on Benjamin Logan. He saw something way back there. 15 yards. What's he saying? Did he push somebody down after the play was over?
Yeah, I don't know. He's signaling like he's pushed his hands to the ground like he must have pushed somebody down after the play was over.
15-yard penalty tacked on. That's going to move the ball all the way out to the 45-yard line. So just like that, Indian Lake gets out of the shadow of their own goalpost and a drive that started at their 10. So Lillard back to work here. First and 10. Couple wide out split left, single to the right. Man in motion to the right side is Clay. They're going to roll to the right to throw. Looking out there is Lillard. Now looking, tucking. Now he's going to fire it down the right sideline, and it's going to go well out of bounds, incomplete. Looking out there for Quest Clay, who is single covered.
What's going on now? Referees are signaling something.
Illegal man downfield on the Lakers.
Yeah, it looks like it, yeah. But I don't see a flag.
You're right. I don't see one either.
Oh, no, there it is. It's shadowed in the 50, yeah.
It was on the 50.
Laying in that gold 50 out there.
5-yard penalty will make it a second down and 15. First and 15, I should say. They got the number 2 over on the sideline there, but it's first and 15 after the penalty. 27-0, all Indian Lake here. Clay in motion. They will run a little counterplay to the cause. Cosby to the 45 as he gets the 5 yards back. It'll be second down and 10.
Be a nice little run there by Cause. And I tell you what, the Lakers, if I'm in, I'm just trying to turn clock right now. I guess you take the strikes as you can get them.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, hey, let's just run our offense right now. We've had a great start to the first quarter, and let's just keep it going here in the second quarter.
Second down and 10. London Red Raiders lead Jonathan Alder right now 15-14 in the first quarter score there. Quarterback keeper for Burke makes one man miss, but not the second guy, as he'll only go forward for about 2 yards. Third and 8 coming up. Good tackle.
Looks like by Hayden Heights, number 25 there for Benjamin Logan, brought him down there at the about the line of scrimmage there. So nice tackle there by Hayden.
Third down and long coming up here. Clock moving, 9:45 to go in the half on WPKO. Lakers taking their time here on this one. Play clock down to 18. And Lillard will get back to work with a couple wide out split right now. They move a man in motion to the right side. He's going to drop the throw. Steps up in the pocket, and he's going to run. He's at the 50, the 45, a first down, as he's knocked out of bounds around the Benjamin Logan 40-yard line as he picks up 15 more yards. And quarterback keeper will get the first down as they're going to mark him at the 39.
That almost looks like a designed run because I'm looking downfield and his wideouts, started blocking, right away as soon as he took off. So, it looked like that might have been dialed up. Hey, if there's nothing there, take off and go. And they just started blocking. So, yeah, nice little pickup gainer there by Lillard.
First and 10 at the 39. And you get the feeling the Laker offense feels like they can do anything about they want.
Yes.
Sweep to Quest Clay, getting to the outside, 35, breaks it down the sideline, 30, 25, tripped up inside the 20-yard line.
I have a feeling that was a touchdown-saving tackle on that one because he was off to the races.
Wow, the poor Graham Falcons. Shawnee Braves 33-0 in the second quarter on Graham.
Whew.
Another team that's had one of the toughest schedules you're going to find is the Graham Falcons.
For a team that's rebuilding, too.
Yeah. First and 10, they're going to give the Lakers the 15-yard line here. As they're on the march again. This drive started at their own 10-yard line. Jet sweep coming around to the left side. Cosby makes it close to the 11-yard line before he's knocked out of bounds. So a second down coming up.
They're definitely trying to stretch out this Benjamin Logan Raiders offense. I mean, they're running sideline to sideline right now, the Indian Lake Lakers are.
Another trip to the red zone for the Lakers.
Yep. Brought to you by Advanced Pools of Ohio, your full-service swimming pool professionals.
Second down and 7. Got 3 on the carry. And Lillard keeps it himself. Bounces out to the right side. Lillard at the 10 with a penalty flag. Makes one man miss. 5 touchdown. But will it hold?
I think there's a holding call there at the line.
It is. Holding on the Lakers. Takes the touchdown off the board. And now Indian Lake will be backed up somewhere around their 22 or 23-yard line, depending on where that penalty took place. 8:44 to go in the half here. 27-0, Indian Lake leads. And they're looking for more. They're going to back them up to the 22. So it'll be a 2nd and 17 from the 22.
I think you run a slant, a post pattern across the middle. If I'm then they're not really D'ing up on Quest Clay, you know, or pressuring him too much, or giving him too much room.
And Lillard keeps it himself, and he's hit by a couple of Raiders and dropped. Line of scrimmage, that's going to be it.
Yeah, nice pressure there by the Benjamin Logan Raiders getting in the backfield and tackling Lillard.
Dillbone in there. Yeah, third down and long now.
I think that play, Lake knew they were going for it, I think, on fourth down regardless down mm-hmm. here in this territory. So they're like, hey, let's just run this little QB sneak and see if we can get some more positive yards.
Third down. Lakers at the 22 of Benjamin Logan. Lillard wants to throw, rolling to his right, looking down the field, dropped the football, picks it up, and he's still scrambling. He's going to come all the way back over to the left, now cut up into the middle of the field and be tackled back at the 25. That's officially going to be a DQ Blizzard Blitz sack of the game.
Yeah, it looks like Lillard tried to pick that, this one to cock it to throw it and just dropped it right out of his hands there.
Our first DQ Blizzard Blitz sack of the night. There's Lillard sucking a little air down there.
Yeah, he's tired.
And now on fourth down and 21, it's going to be pretty much Hail Mary time here. They're going to just send everybody down to the field and just throw it up and see what happens. Because you can't punt from here. You can't kick a field goal.
So they got to get down to what, the 6 or 7?
Yes. Yeah, it looks like the 6-yard line. All right, here we go. Fourth down. Low snap. Lillard, it's kicked, and it's loose, and Lillard just falls on it at the 31. So the Raiders get a nice break there, and that's officially another DQ Blizzard Blitz sack.
Yeah, some mistakes there by the Lakers and just really hurt themselves. Cost them a touchdown on that drive right there between that holding call.
Yeah, and your coach, Rapp, you played the best first quarter you could possibly imagine. You played a pretty solid second quarter, and you were driving down from the 10-yard line.
Yeah.
And then you have those plays happen right there. Benjamin Logan turns him away.
Look at the Dallas Cowboys.
First and 10 Raiders at their own 31. Here's Hughes back at quarterback. Solly Hughes led him down the field last time. It stalled at the 10, though. He's going to roll to pass on first down. Fires out, has a man out there, caught at the 45, and tiptoes out of bounds is number 15, Gavin Troth, with his first catch of the night. Man, that was a nice play by Hughes. He had to get it over to defender.
Yeah. I tell you what, the offense has a little more pep in its step, I think, when Hughes is under center right now.
First and 10. Clock stops at 7:02. Left to go in the half here. Tomorrow night, the big homecoming dance out here at Benjamin Logan is celebrating homecoming out here this week. Couple wideout split left. They're going to split three to the right now. Play clock down to eight. Hughes looking to throw. Looks left. Looks in the middle of the field now. And it's tipped and incomplete. Getting a hand on it in there that time was Logan Murphy.
Yeah, legal man downfield on that one?
I think somebody was covered up. That's
okay.
My guess.
All right.
I think maybe you decline this if you're Indian Lake. Yeah, looks like they're going to decline it and take the down.
And a holding call.
Oh, and a hold. So they'll take the hold then.
Yeah.
First and 20.
Man, I can't remember when the last time I've seen. I guess he might have been covered up. We don't get a speaker call, but you know, legal man down the field in high school football. I haven't seen that called that many times. Especially twice in one night already.
Especially on a pass play like that.
It's
you know?
Fast.
I mean, usually it's like on a screen or something.
Yeah.
Or it might be, you know, where they think the quarterback's going to run and he throws. But not on that, something like that, yeah. Dillbone splits or moves his motion to the left side of the line. Here's a pump fake. They're going to come back and look for him. And it is picked
right
off by
him.
The Lakers with a flag down. He's going to take it to the house for a touchdown on an interception return. Is Indian Lake in big number 51. That is Emery Wagner with the pick six.
They try to set up a screen. There's a flag on the play, though, so it'll be interesting to see what the flag is. It's got to be against in the backfield. So I would think it'd be against Benjamin Logan, but they're talking about it.
It cannot be roughing the passer. And they're going to call it.
Oh, my goodness.
You can't call roughing the passer when he throws it right into the defensive lineman and they pick it off.
Right. And the quarterback chased him down to the end zone. So how did he get roughing the passer? He was on the ground.
That's a perplexing one, but you know what? It bails the Benjamin Logan Raiders out because instead of
a touchdown,
instead
for
of a pick six,
yeah,
it's all the way out to the 49-yard line.
I don't understand that call.
I'd like to get a rules analyst in on that one.
Yeah, where's Dean Blandino? What's his retainer?
How you get a roughing the passer when he throws it into the defensive lineman who picks it off and runs it for a pick six, and the quarterback was actually chasing him down for.
Yeah, I guess I don't understand.
First and 10 to the 49-yard line. Benjamin Logan to take the points off the board. And Hughes to throw, rolling to his left. Slings it out there. Man out there caught. And right at the sticks, near a first down. Good pass play. Boy, he didn't get a favorable spot. They're going to give him 9 yards.
Yeah.
Colin Powell gets the catch. So it'll be second and 1. Clock at 6:28 to go in the half here.
I tell you what, I'm going back on PeakofOhioTV tomorrow. I'm going to watch that play over again. I just don't get it. Yeah, I can understand if he was on the ground, but he tried to make the tackle into the end zone to stop the touchdown.
I don't even get it when it's on the ground because the defender had the football.
Yeah.
I mean.
I don't get roughing the passer.
Yeah, I mean, the quarterback's kind of in play then when the defender gets it. So quick pass, skipped in there, incomplete. Just short-armed that one as he was looking for Gavin Troth. It'll be 3rd and 1.
You look at it, the throw was only about, you know, 3 yards, but he actually had to throw the ball in the air about 20 because he's trying to throw it back across the field. So that's a hard throw for a young quarterback to make.
3rd and 1 at the Indian Lake 42-yard line. Raiders looking to extend the drive here. A lot of motion for the Raider offense. And now they got to burn another timeout. 27-0. Indian Lake leads here. 3rd and 1 for Benjamin Logan. We'll take time as well. More high school football coming up after this on 98.3 WPKO and peakofohiotv.com.
Nashville Hot Mac and Cheese Bowl with breast strip bites tossed in Nashville Hot flavor, all nestled into a bowl of mac and cheese. It's a meal with a kick. Try the Nashville Hot Mac and Cheese Bowl, only at Lee's.
Looking to save money every month? Well, who isn't? With a Quest MasterCard, you can lock in a low fixed interest rate from 5.99 to 11.9% APR for qualified cardholders. You can even perform balance transfers from other high interest cards and save real money every month. Apply online today. Membership and credit score eligibility required. Quest Federal Credit Union. Explore the possibilities. NCUA insured, equal opportunity.
Two slings in the middle of the football field and incomplete as he had a third down and one, and they're passing on third and one. Incomplete. Looking for Kendall Pleichert, so it'll be fourth and one for the Raiders at the Laker 42-yard line.
That's an interesting call.
Well, my guess is they know they're going for it on fourth, so why not give it a shot? How about the battle of 6-0s up at Waynesfield? First quarter play, Elgin 8, Waynesfield Goshen 6.
Woo! That's going to be a good game over there.
Fourth and one for the Raiders at the Laker 42. And they're going to throw on fourth and one. Hughes fires out, and it is knocked away incomplete. Good defensive play by Quest Clay, and it's a turnover on downs. That's a head-scratcher to me, Rick. You got fourth and one. Why not try to run?
I don't understand that. I mean, they were getting some positive, you know, one. They were getting a couple yards at a time on the running game.
Yeah.
With hassle. So I guess I'm perplexed on that one as well. Especially it stops the clock, too. Gives the Lakers the ball back with 5:50 left to go in the second.
And you know what? I mean, they had second and one on that series. Three straight passes. Turn it over on downs, and the Indian Lake offense will take back over. Up 27 to nothing here with 5:49 to play in the half. So Burke Lillard back to work. Quarterback keeper Burke bounces to the outside. Burke is out of bounds short of the 50-yard line on a nice pickup on first down. Is that a penalty flag laying over there on the far side?
Looks like it. Holding.
Holding on the Lakers.
Hmm. I tell you what, been a lot of laundry here the last couple minutes of this game, and not so favorable against the Lakers either. I tell you, look, Lakers have they've 12 points have been erased off the board for them.
Yeah, from penalties.
Yeah.
First down and long coming up. First down and 20. A couple wideouts split left. Burke Lillard to throw in the pocket, looking, steps up, a little pressure, gets out of it, rolls to his left, fires down the sideline, has his man caught. Reisinger's got it out to the 49 near the 50. They're going to give him the midfield stripe, and that's going to set up second down and two.
Nice job for Lillard to get out of pressure on that one and not take off run. I liked how he kept his eyes down the field and found his open receiver there and puts him down in second manageable now.
Well, I'll tell you what. You don't see this score too often in high school football. Second quarter, Upper Scioto Valley 53, Crestline 0.
Wow.
Second down and two for the Lake. Sweep to Quest Clay. He gets free of one tackler. He steps up on the right side, 45-yard line. Little jitterbug coming across the middle of the field again. 40, 35, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5 to the house. It's Quest Clay.
Wow. I tell you what, that was a 50-yard technically run, but he ran for about 75 because he ran on one side of the field all the way to the other. My goodness.
That's impressive.
I tell you what, man, we taught him, man. Chad, I think he's the new Swiss Army knife for the Lakers.
Yeah, he's a difference maker too.
Yeah, he's a little tired on that one. He put his hands on his knees. I'd be a little tired after that run too. So brings up this PAT, and this PAT is brought to you by Fissel's Floor Covering. Covering a reputation you can stand on.
33 to nothing, PAT coming up here. And looking around the horizon, there's a bad moon horizon over there.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that. And it's been all Lakers out here tonight. Here comes the snap and hold. The kick is up, and it is good. 4:49 to go in the first half. All Indian Lake on the Quest Federal Credit Union scoreboard. 34 to nothing. Let's take another timeout. More coming up after this on 98.3 WPKO and PeakofOhioTV.com.
When you're craving pizza, call Bedrone's Pizza of Bell Fountain, 592-1020. You'll get it freshly made just for you. If pizza isn't what you're craving, they have a variety of sandwiches and dinners sure to please. Bedrone's Pizza of Bell Fountain, 592-1020.
Hi, it's Liz at Bell Fountains Comfort Inn, reminding you we offer your out-of-town guests a comfortable alternative. Available amenities include in-room microwave and fridge, complimentary breakfast, outdoor pool, and on-site lounge. And king rooms come with hot tubs. It really does beat crowding into your house, and we're pet-friendly too. Reservations are easy at choicehotels.com or call 937-599-5555. That's Bell Fountains Comfort Inn.
Welcome back to Benjamin Logan, another Dairy Queen of Bell Fountain kickoff here on WPKO. You know what I had, Dairy Queen, here recently? The Snickerdoodle Blizzard.
Yeah, pretty good.
Mmm, tasty. Dairy Queen of Bell Fountain. There's the Raiders at the 15-yard line. Plykert at the 20. Trying to bounce outside. Gets one tackle off. Now he's going backwards, and he will not get much after that. Let's see where they give him forward progress. 34 to nothing. Indian Lake in front. Benjamin Logan coming out on offense here. And you can just tell now, Rick. I mean, look at, you know, Benjamin Logan. It's kind of slow getting on and off the field.
Oh, yeah. That was a gasser back there, that run for Quest Clay, I mean.
Yeah.
That was old Chris Berman, like, whoop.
Yes, it was impressive. Here's Sully Hughes back out to run the show. It's been pretty much Hughes all the way since the first quarter. Andrick's got the first two series, I believe.
Yes.
22-yard line. They're going to throw. Looking down the middle of the football field. Got a man out there, and he underthrows him. Incomplete knockdown. But he had Gavin Troff behind the defense.
He puts a little bit of air underneath that one. That's 6 points to the house. Nice jump by Burke Lillard, though, to jump up there and put his hand out there and knock that one down.
Second down and 10. Riverside leads Lehman 14-7 now in that ball game over there at Lehman.
Man, I'm still speechless. So I hope Platfoot's okay.
Yeah, we're going to be at Riverside next week to see him take on Miami East. Second and 10, handoff here. Running back squeaks through and makes it to the 25-yard line where he'll pick up 3 yards. Third down and 7 coming up. And that's Hassel there on the carry.
I tell you what, your coach Jenny here, you need a first down. I mean, you still got 4 minutes left to go in this quarter, and you're only at the 24-yard line, 25-yard line, and you do not want to give the Lakers the ball back.
Right. It's a running clock as of right now to start the second half should this score hold as it is. So third and 7 from the 25. Dillbone in motion. Hughes to throw, rolling to his left, looking, slings it, and he's got his man complete. Colin Powell with a first down, gets a big hit at the 37-yard line. He hangs on to the football. Tell you what, Colin's not a very big kid either.
No, he's not.
He's 5'8 and a 140. But he took a lick there and held on to the football. First and 10.
And, you know, the Benjamin Logan is definitely not in a hurry.
No, a lot of time running off the play clock here.
Yeah.
First and 10 at their own 37-yard line. Hughes looking to throw again. Good protection in the pocket. Going for a deep one down the right side. It's up for grabs, and it's picked off. An easy pickoff for Quest Clay. Just playing center field that time. Receiver really never even looked back for the ball.
Yeah.
And it's the third pick of the half for the Indian Lake defense. Technically, it's the third one. It's been the fourth one, though. That one got called back from a penalty.
Right. Those are, I hate to say it, but that's just a growing pain right now for the Benjamin Logan offense. I mean, you got a freshman quarterback, and apparently Coach Jenny thinks that one's to assume by the playing time that he's the next man up for this team. So
they're going to ride with him, I think, from here on out. Get him the experience now. So first and 10, Lakers at their own 31, already up 34 to nothing. How about the Bell Fountain Chiefs? They're up 28 nothing right now on Tecumseh. Bounce back game for them. Handoff, Cosby. Left side of the line, Cosby breaks free, rolls over a guy at the 39-yard line. And slow to get up there after that, taking that big hit. Cosby helps him up, which is really nice.
Yeah.
Everett Clapsaddle's the guy that took the tough end of that hit.
Yeah, came walking off a little bit. I think his shoulder's hurting him. He's pointing to his shoulder.
Second down and 2, the Cos gets 8. Couple wideout split left for the Lakers here. They will fake the handoff. And, oh, it's loose on the ground.
Oh.
And I think Benjamin Logan might have got this ball inside the 40-yard line.
They do.
Miscommunication between Cosby and Lillard that time. And Indian Lake turns it over with 2:39 to play in the half.
Not been a very clean second quarter for the Lakers.
You're right.
Into the penalties, the 2 touchdowns called back. The fumble, you know, the fumbles, the drop snaps, the drive, you know, they had a couple drives, one last drive they stopped that way because of the bad snaps. So I think Coach Rapp, you know, you look at it and say, well, he's up 34-0, but I think you're still coaching.
Yeah.
And you're telling your team, hey, this second quarter has not really been our greatest performance.
37-yard line. Benjamin Logan sets up first and 10. Chance to get some points on the board before halftime. Five wide receiver set here. Hughes back to work. Looks to his left. Flyers out into the flat. It's incomplete off the hands of his intended receiver, Kendall Pleichard. Second down and 10. Also want to thank Byhalia providing our internet services out here tonight, byhalia.net. Check them out. Helping us out here at peakofohio.com or peakofohiotv.com tonight. byhalia.net, serving Logan, Union, Hardin, and Marion counties. Second down and 10. Hughes rolls to throw. Looking, tucks it down now. Gets by one guy. Now he's going to tuck and run. Now he just dumps it out incomplete. That's a smart play. He avoided a sack.
Yeah.
And it'll be a third down and 10.
But I tell you what, the Lakers defense was barreling down on him.
Yes. Now, the only thing I would say is throw it out of bounds.
Right, yeah.
You know, don't throw it inbounds. Yeah. If you land an incomplete inbounds, but in the future you're going to want to throw that out of bounds, not give anybody a chance to pick that off.
Yeah, don't ground check that one.
Third down and 10 now. Ben Logan trying to take advantage of a turnover. 2:26 to go in the half here. Couple wideouts split to the left. And Hughes, play action. Rolling to his left to throw. Fires in the middle of the field. Tipped and incomplete. Looking for Powell, who took a hit from Reisinger that time. It's incomplete. Fourth and 10. Tell you what, we got to give the Indian Lake secondary some credit out here. They're laying some hits tonight.
I talked about it from word go. I mean, they definitely were making some tackles tonight and making some, you know, nothing egregious, nothing like that. I mean, they're just nice, solid, hard hits.
Yeah, and they're defending the pass well.
Yeah.
Fourth and 10 from the Laker 37. Raiders break the huddle. Plenty of time on the play clock. 2:20 on the game clock here in the second quarter. Man in motion. They will fake to him. They're going to throw. Hughes looking. Middle of the field going down. He has a man open. Off the hands of Powell. Incomplete. That would have been 6 points, but it's a turnover on downs.
Man, he couldn't draw a better play than that one. He had him wide open. And I tell you what, Hughes was sitting there like, hey, that's a touchdown, baby, and then just dropped it. That's the type of first half the Ben Logan team's had.
Yeah, and we talked before as it's growing pains. I mean, it's growing pains. And that's one of those growing pains. I mean, maybe when they got a little more experience, that ball's caught for 6.
Yeah.
34-0 here on 98.3 WPKO in favor of the Indian Lake Lakers. And the Lakers back to work here. They're going to throw. Burke Lillard rolling to his right. Fires down the right sideline. Has Quest Clay out there and off his fingertips. Incomplete at the Benjamin Logan 30-yard line.
You do not see him dropping passes like that.
No, and I thought when I first saw that throw, I thought that's going to be out of bounds. But actually, Burke threw a pretty good ball there.
Yeah, dropped one in there. I think Quest thought he might have been running. I think he checked his feet a little bit and just lost sight of the ball and bumbled it out of his hand because it was close to the sideline on that one. But, man, that was a nice throw by Lillard.
Second down and 10. Clock stopped at 2:08. Man, this has been a long first half here. Second down and 10 for the Lakers. And I think he's down.
Yeah, his knee touched the ground when he picked that ball up.
Low snap. And Lillard went down on a knee to get it, so he's officially down. There's another miscue by the Lakers. Third down, and he's going to lose
about
six yards?
Yeah.
Third and 16.
I think if you're either one of these coaches, Jenny or Rabbi, you're kind of like, all right, let's get the second quarter out of here. This is one we want to just rip this one up and throw it out.
Yeah, I mean, I know you're Coach Rapp. It's going to be hard to complain. You're up 34-0, but, yeah, you're right. They've had a lot of miscues in the second quarter.
Yeah.
And they're going to burn their first time out of the half with 1:38 to go in the half. We'll take another timeout as well. 34-0 Lakers. More coming up after this on 98.3 WPKO and PeakofOhioTV.com.
Looking for a way to make your gun even more awesome? Come down to Patriot's Attic and get yourself a silencer. We take care of all the paperwork and fingerprints in-house, so the most stressful part for you is deciding which can to buy. The best part? When you buy a silencer at Patriot's Attic, you're free to take it out of jail and use it on our range whenever you want while you're waiting for that form to be approved. So make that wait time worth it and come see us on County Road 130 between Huntsville and Bell Fountain.
Dream about a pool for your family? Advanced Pools of Ohio has your summer fun in mind. From choosing the right pool size to professional installation, maintenance, and the chemicals to keep your pool looking great all season long. Find them at advancedpoolsofohio.com or check out the store located on 273 outside of Bell Center. Advanced Pools of Ohio.
Welcome back to Benjamin Logan. Timeout Indian Lake. 1:38 to play in the half. Third down and long. Burke Lillard to throw. Setting up a screen to Cosby, and it's snuffed out, and the Raiders tackling for a loss. Great play in there is Jason Bowman comes in there and blows it up.
Yeah, this looks like the offensive lineman. I mean, obviously, it's hard not to block downfield on that screen pass. They've been calling it all night long. But he just got off the block pretty well easy and just made the tackle. I think they're going to go. They got to drop back and kick it.
Yeah, they'll drop back and kick this. They're going to run every bit of this play clock down as it's going to get inside a minute to go in the first half. Benjamin Logan will drop Caden Brown back deep to receive this punt. High snap brought in, though. Punter gets it out of there. Good high punt. And it will take a Laker bounce. And then
punted off the Lake. I think it bounced off the Benjamin Logan
guy. It did. It hit a Raider, and the Lakers are going to recover at the 42-yard line. And, yes, there's the sign right there.
Yeah.
Another Raiders turnover. That is the fifth Raider turnover of the half.
He just didn't look at the ball and see where it was going.
Yeah.
I mean, he just was running down the field and took a bounce. It hit him right off the leg.
Fifth turnover, and there was one called back, by the way. That would have been a sixth.
Yeah.
On the interception that was taken away from the penalty flag. And a couple turnovers on downs, too. Lakers back to work. Lillard, he's going to fire down the right sideline looking for his man. He's got it out there, and it's out of bounds for Risinger. He had the defender beat.
Yeah, Lillard just led him too far out of bounds.
40 seconds to go in the half here on WPKO Bell Fountain. Second down and 10 at the Raider 42-yard line. Get you caught up on some scores here before we break for halftime on WPKO and PeakofOhioTV.com. Some interesting scores going on tonight. Some good close games.
High-profile games.
Big matchups tonight. Big computer points out there. Lillard the throw again. Rolls to his left. Rolls. A little bit of pressure. Now he's going to come back into the middle of the field. Gets by one tackler. He's going to try to run. He's hit from behind. And he's going to go forward for some positive yards. But, man, that's dangerous in the middle of the football field that way. As Burke did hang on to the ball, they're going to call a timeout with 21 seconds to go in the half. So I guess we'll take another timeout as well. 34-0. Indian Lake leads. More high school football after this on 98.3 WPKO and PeakofOhioTV.com.
When you're hungry for great Italian food, but you're also in a hurry, try Fazoli's of Bell Fountain. They offer delicious Italian meals like spaghetti and meatballs and chicken Alfredo fettuccine. They also offer great pizza and oven-baked subs. Be sure to download their rewards app. You'll get special offers, plus every dollar you spend, you get reward points to spend on future purchases. Fazoli's of Bell Fountain, open till 9.
You love that glow your skin gets from the sun? At Buckeye Wash and Tan, you can keep that glow all year round. You don't have to worry about the seasons changing either. They have several beds available to help you achieve and keep the look you want. Check out Buckeye Wash and Tan at either of their two Bell Fountain locations.
Welcome back to Benjamin Logan. Indian Lake burns a timeout. 21 seconds to go in the half. Third and 6 from the Raiders' 38-yard line. Lillard back to pass into the pocket. He's going to go deep down the left side. Got a man out there. Quest Clay jumps, grabs. First and goal coming up for the Lakers on another great catch by Quest Clay.
Man, he is making some things happen tonight out there, Quest Clay is. I tell you what, that drops him in the red zone. And that's brought to you by Advanced Pools of Ohio, your full-service swimming pool professionals. And it looks like the Lakers took a timeout.
Their last timeout. We're going to keep it right here on this one as the Lakers are getting ready to try to punch one in with 13 seconds to go in the half. And You know, we're talking during the break, Rick. I mean, you're up 34-0. Some people say, man, why are they going for more points? But I think it's Coach Rapp saying, all right, we got to end this half with something good because their second quarter has not been the most clean quarter for the Lakers,
no.
That's for sure.
Yeah, been very sloppy for the Lakers here in the second quarter of this matchup. And you look at it and say, whoa, 34-0. I mean, how sloppy can it be?
Right.
Yeah, it's not. But they've had 12 points erased off the board in this second quarter. So right.
And penalties and turnover. Yeah. And the other thing is this, too. I mean, it's still the second quarter. You still got to go out and you got to play.
Yeah.
I mean, in the second half, we're going to see them, you know, pull back a little. I'm sure the starters will be out by the end of the third quarter.
I would assume so, yeah.
But, I mean, you still got to play. They got to stay sharp. They got Shawnee next week.
Yep.
I mean, that's a showdown in CBC Mad River. First and goal at the three. Man in motion to the right side of the line. Burke Little is going to roll to throw. Looking. I think he might be able to run this in. He's going to toss in the back of the end zone, and it's knocked down incomplete. Well, maybe Burke could take that one in.
Yeah, he seems a little frustrated. Burke seems a little frustration on that one there a little bit there. Like he was looking for something a little bit different that he didn't get.
Now, here's the thing. If Indian Lake does try to run and they don't make it in, no timeouts, so the clock will run out.
Yeah. I think he's got to be smart. He got to realize that, hey, you got 7 seconds.
That's the other thing here. I mean, if it's not there for Burke on this second down play, you can't be rolling around because you're going to run the clock out.
Right. Don't take a sack. The only option is end zone.
Yes. End zone and make a quick play. Second and goal. Rolling to his right again to throw. Clock moving at 5 seconds. Burke back of the end zone. Man's open. Caught. Touchdown. Madden Lillard. 3 yards out with 1 second on the clock.
Ooh, I did not see him in the back of the end zone, but good thing Lillard's down there on the field, or his brother did, Burke to Madden, and nice little pitch and catch there. Brings up another PAT brought to you by Fissel's Floor Covering, covering a reputation you can stand on.
Makes it 40-0 with the extra point coming up. And we'll have the running clock in the second half to start the third quarter. Here comes the PAT. And it is up, and it is good by Cummins again. 1 second to go in the half. Indian Lake, 41. Benjamin Logan, nothing. Let's take our 800th break of the first half. You're listening to High School Football on 98.3 WPKO and PeakofOhioTV.com.
Looking to save money every month? Well, who isn't? With a Quest MasterCard, you can lock in a low fixed interest rate from 5.99 to 11.9% APR for qualified cardholders. You can even perform balance transfers from other high interest cards and save real money every month. Apply online today. Membership and credit score eligibility required. Quest Federal Credit Union. Explore the possibilities. NCUA insured. Equal opportunity lender.
Just one visit and you'll know why it's worth the drive to Firehouse Pizza in Zanesfield. This weekend, try a specialty pizza like the Fireman's Italian. Think about an Italian sub on a pizza. Or the mac and cheese with ranch, bacon, and 4 different cheeses. Firehouse Pizza. Check their Facebook page for specials.
Welcome back to Benjamin Logan. Another Dairy Queen kickoff here on 98.3 WPKO. The foot of the Indian Lake kickers are going to be sore tonight. They've been kicking a lot. Squib kick picked up by the Raiders. That'll run out the half as they are down at the 32-yard line. And that will end the first half of play. A half dominated by Indian Lake, 41-0, Rick. Wow.
Yeah, I mean, the first quarter, couldn't ask for a better start for the Indian Lake Lakers coming out there and just really putting it to them there in that first quarter. Second quarter, it was a little ugly out there on both sides of the football, throwing interceptions, penalties,
yeah.
Points coming off the board. Long second quarter. But Lakers going in 41-0 at halftime. And, hey, man, if you're a Coach Rapp, you're saying, hey, baby, let's roll.
Yeah, they're up 41-0. And if you're Coach Jenny and Benjamin Logan, I mean, I don't think you're, I mean, as upset about, you know, being down at halftime as of how you're down. 5 turnovers.
Yeah. Five turnovers is just one that you really can't have out there, especially with a team, you know, that is trying to get things moving in the right direction, trying to build off that win they had last week, and then this not really things going their way tonight. And I have a feeling it's going to be growing pains the rest of the year for the Benjamin Logan Raiders.
Well, let's look at some other games going on from around the area tonight as we head to the scoreboard. Urbana is rolling up on Kenton Ridge 31-7 at halftime, and a game really that Urbana needs if they want to make it into the playoffs. But they're rolling big. Shawnee Braves are pounding the Grand Falcons 40-0 halftime there. Shawnee and Indian Lake play next week. The London Red Raiders are leading the Jonathan Alder Pioneers. What a score here. 22-21, second quarter action. That's a big showdown in the CBC. Bell Fountain is blasting Tecumseh 28-0 on 107.3 The Drive. And it's North Union 14, Northwestern nothing in the first half of play there. OHC play, the big showdown on 106.9 The Bull. West Liberty-Salem leads West Jefferson 27-21. What a high-scoring game in the first half that is for the Frank and Caleb down there at West Jefferson tonight.
Yeah, they got a nice, interesting game down there. I thought West Liberty pulled away a little bit earlier, but Rough Riders are not going to go away easy.
Northeastern leads Triad 30-6. Greenan is beating Madison Plains 20-3 at halftime. The Greenan Knights are winless on the season. Cedarville's up on Catholic Central 14-0. Greenview leads Southeastern 12-7. Mechanicsburg beating the stuffing out of Fairbanks 40-0 at halftime down there at Berg. In the TRC, Riverside leads Lehman 14-7 at halftime. The big story there, Miles Platfoot, their starting quarterback for Riverside, out with a leg injury, carted off in the second quarter. Milton Union 48-0 over Covington in there. The Bethel Bees and Northridge Polar Bears 6-3 ball game down there in that one. The big showdown in the NWCC tonight is 6-0 Waynesfield against 6-0 Elgin. 12-8 Waynesfield at halftime. Looking elsewhere, the Golden Gophers of Ridgemont are not faring so well against Hardin Northern. That's a 21-0 score there in the first half. A couple max scores here. Versailles leads Anna 21-0 at halftime. New Bremen is losing to St. Henry 13-7 at halftime. And Marion Local 28-0 over Fort Recovery and Coldwater 35-7 over Delphus St. John's. I'll tell you what, Marion Local and Coldwater are looking like they're destined for another 9-0 versus 9-0 at the end of the season.
Yeah, that's going to be a good showdown in the MAC. As the MAC always is, a good showdown there over there. And so it'd be an interesting game to watch for sure.
Our score at halftime here is Indian Lake 41, Benjamin Logan nothing. We're going to turn things over now to the PeakofOhioTV.com crew. You're going to catch the Indian Lake Marching Band performing their halftime show here. As we'll return with second half action, Rick and I will in just a bit here from Benjamin Logan High School.
At Easton Water, we're fully committed to fulfilling our promises to our customers. As a locally owned, staffed, and operated company, our reputation is critical, and we mean what we say. We want to be your trusted source for everything water. If recent changes in the market have left you high and dry when it comes to drinking water, water softeners, salt, or anything else to do with the water in your home or business, we're here for you and would love to be your trusted water partner. Visit eastonwater.com or give us a call, and we'll get you added to our route.
Donato's Pizza's open late tonight. Order online and pick it up after the game. Go to Donato's.com. Sign up for Donato's Rewards and turn it into free rewards with free food. Donato's, every piece is important. South Main, Bell Fountain, and online at Donato's.com.
We'll be right back. Our show wouldn't be complete without Thriller.
Looking for a hobby that brings out your creativity? Crockpot Studio offers many classes to help you. From beginner's pottery to advanced, there's sure to be a class you'll love. Learn to create your own masterpieces from a chunk of clay to something beautiful. For openings, check out their Facebook page. On Wednesdays from noon till 8 and select Sundays, there's paint your own. Just purchase a ceramic piece there and paint. Lots to choose from for your home or for gifts. Have fun, relax, meet new people, and be creative at Crackpot Studio.
At Bell Fountain's Best Car Wash, we take care of your vehicle 100%, from the first drop of hot, clean water to the last stroke of our super soft, shine-enhancing towel. And you can choose from four levels of clean, basic, plus, premium, and ultimate, starting at just $8. Bell Fountain's Best Car Wash, 720 South Main.
Thank you.
too.
Gathering Place in downtown West Liberty serves breakfast all day, every day. They have homemade desserts, made-from-scratch noodles, and the salad bar is open Wednesday through Sunday. But on Fridays, they are serving up all-you-can-eat fish. Yes, that's right, it's all-you-can-eat fish on Fridays. Enjoy golden fried fish with your choice of two sides, and maybe finish it off with one of their homemade desserts. Don't miss the all-you-can-eat fish every Friday at the Liberty Gathering Place, open until 7.
Colmar Insurance Agency in DeGraff offers insurance coverage for home, life, auto, commercial, and farm. Visit their website at ColmarInsuranceAgency.com for their number and more information. Colmar Insurance Agency, specializing in helping you with the right coverage.
Looking for a hobby that brings out your creativity? Crockpot Studio offers many classes to help you. From beginner's pottery to advanced, there's sure to be a class you'll love. Learn to create your own masterpieces from a chunk of clay to something beautiful. For openings, check out their Facebook page. On Wednesdays from noon till 8 and select Sundays, there's Paint Your Own. Just purchase a ceramic piece there and paint. Lots to choose from for your home or for gifts. Have fun, relax, meet new people, and be creative at Crackpot Studio.
Attention, Fat Boys Pizza and Ice Cream customers. It's that time again. It's football time. Get your Fat Boys fix before the game. Or order while the game's going on. We're open till 10. We have hot pizzas, subs, and salads. 592-FATS.
Are you penalized because your bank's head coach is located out of town? At the People Savings Bank, our head coach is right here in your hometown to help you meet your goals. Come score a touchdown with the People Savings Bank. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Are you looking for a place to tan or do your laundry? Buckeye Wash and Tan has you covered. Their goal is to provide you the highest level service and products in a clean and friendly environment at an affordable price. Their laundry facility is fast, reliable, and saves you time. Full service will take care of the laundry for you. There's always an attendant on duty. Ohio weather can be dreary at times. Getting a tan helps you feel good all year long, regardless of the weather. They provide clean and well-maintained beds to help you feel your best. Let Buckeye Wash and Tan brighten your clothes and your day.
Have you tried this month's Blizzard of the Month at the Dairy Queen of Urbana? It's the Caramel Fudge Cheesecake. You'll find cheesecake pieces and salted caramel pieces covered in fudge. Try one today at the Dairy Queen of Urbana.
Hi, everybody. This is Dr. Jacob from Elevate Chiropractic, Bell Fountain's newest chiropractic clinic. Aren't you tired of being in pain and not living life to your fullest? Chiropractic care not only relieves pain, but more importantly, it helps your body handle stress better in the long term. We tailor every adjustment specific to you with the help of our in-house digital x-ray suite, along with corrective stretches and exercises. It's time to take back control of your own health today. Visit ElevateChiroCare.com or call 937-210-5525 to schedule now.
This month is designated September, and 107.3 The Drive is saluting the band whose sound became synonymous with heavy metal itself. The Drive will play a whole lot of lead. With blocks of Sept. Concert specials, deep cuts, double shots, live cuts, and Led Zeppelin pop culture moments as we celebrate all things Led Zeppelin during the month of September on 107.3 The Drive.
The Indian Lake Lakers on top of the Benjamin Logan Raiders. And we'll have a running clock here, Rick, to start the second half of play. And as we get ready for the third quarter, Indian Lake actually gets the football, by the way, to start the third quarter. But if you're Coach Jenny and the Raiders, I mean, now, I mean, what they've been doing a lot this season, you got to come out and win the third quarter.
Yeah, come out and win the third quarter if you're the Benjamin Logan Raiders. And I think, I hate to say this, but you're really, Coach Jenny, throw that first half out of the way. Yeah. And now you start trying to build on stuff. Run your offense. Try to be, precise in what you want to do and win the third quarter. Start back at a 0-0 ball game. Obviously, it's not going to be a 0-0 ball game because the clock's going to be running and stuff like that. But I think if that's the way, if you're the Benjamin Logan Raiders, and if I'm Coach Jenny, that's the way I'm treating it. And let's just go out there and let's see if we can start executing more efficiently than we were in the first half with and not have five turnovers.
Right. Yeah, that was the big key in the first half. Five turnovers by Benjamin Logan. And Indian Lake was putting up points in a flurry there as they scored four in the first quarter alone, four touchdowns, including a muffed punt that was taken in for a touchdown. And then they had a couple of picks, a fumble they picked up. It was going all Indian Lake in the first quarter play. They were out to a 27-0 lead in the first quarter. Now they lead at 41-0 as we start the third quarter action here on WPKO in the backyard brawl. And tee it up, brought to you by Dairy Queen of Bell Fountain.
No, realistically, Chad, it could be like 53 to nothing because
you've right.
Got 12 points called back for the Indian Lake Lakers tonight.
Yeah, they have, including a pick six that came off the board. And here's the kick. Lakers come up in field. They're crossing the 15-yard line out to the 20, 25, and a flag flies near the 30-yard line as making the return that time was Drayden Stevenson, number 7.
I tell you what, man, that official, he must be trying out for quarterback. He threw that flag like 30 yards.
Yes, he did. And I'm guessing this is going to go on Indian Lake.
I think he's calling a legal block in the back.
Probably going to see a few of those in the Lakers in the second half, my prediction is.
Let's see what they're trotting out here. I think you still go first team until the end of the third quarter if it was me.
I think so, and it looks like there's Burke Lillard back at quarterback.
Yep.
Yeah. What you're not going to do is do anything crazy.
Yeah.
I mean, you're not going to do any trick plays or anything like that. But, yeah, you got to keep your starting O out there. There's the Cos on first down. Cosby takes it forward for a couple. Second down and long. Running clock out here. But, yeah, I mean, because, again, Coach Rapp's got to think about Springfield Shawnee next week.
Yes.
Who's putting a beating on Graham right now, by the way.
Right.
Last we saw, that was 40-0. So, I mean, in all likelihood, that game next week is for the CBC Mad River.
Yeah, I would think so, yeah, for that. And, man, just think of that, where the Lakers were last year to go back to compete for the Mad River side of things. I mean, that's a good turnaround.
Second down, Cosby again. Cosby through the hole to the 25, setting up a third and five coming up here for Indian Lake. But, yeah, Shawnee is, man, they're looking good. And when I saw them go into the Mad River, they're the ones that go into the Mad River. Urbana went to the Kenton Trail. I was like, oh, boy. The Mad River just got a little
tougher.
More interesting. Yeah. Yes. Actually, Shawnee's beating Graham right now 47-0. That game's already in the fourth quarter, by the way. They have a running clock there, of course. A lot of running clocks in the CBC tonight. And here they go through the hole. First down for Cosby, who darts through there. First down across the 35 to the 36.
Hey, he came up firing up after that tackle, man. He says, feed me the ball, coach. Let's go.
About the only game that is not a blowout in the CBC tonight is the Jonathan Alder London game, which is 22-21 London.
I tell you what, if you're a Chieftain follower, you're watching Urbana and you're watching Jonathan Alder.
Two games coming up on their schedule. Sweep coming up to Quest Clay around the left side, 35-40. Quest still on his feet out near midfield for another first down.
That was a nice 15-yard gain there by Quest Clay on that sweep around the end. I tell you what, Chad, they like that play. That's like the third time tonight they've ran that, and he's got positive yards every time.
First and 10 at midfield are the Lakers. That's going to be an interesting game next week. Shawnee at Indian Lake, by the way.
Urbana at Bell Fountain.
Urbana at Bell Fountain. Homecoming for the Chiefs next week. First and 10, Lakers in midfield. And pitch play out to the Cos. Cosby spins at the 50, stuffed right there. Minimal pickup there on first down. Second and long. And actually now they're going to give him just the line of scrimmage. So second and 10. Big old bright full moon up overhead of us right now.
Yeah, what did they say? It's like last two nights, I think it's what they call the AK, maybe the supermoon.
Mm-hmm.
Fall is setting in.
I know, but you wouldn't know by the temperatures.
Yeah, you wouldn't know. I mean, it has been fairly nice to us.
It's going to be like 80 next week, too.
Yeah. I'll take it.
Yes. Second and 10 for the Lakers at midfield. Hand off Cosby with a penalty flag. This play will not happen. 5-yard penalty, second down and 15.
Probably a good thing they had a false start there because I think Cos had daylight for miles there on that run up the middle.
Yeah. Talked to Coach Rapp here today for our pregame show and asked him actually on the pregame, did he ever think his team would be vying for a playoff spot in 4-2 after 6 weeks back in like June and July? He said, no, not really. I mean, and this team's come a long way.
It has come a long way, yeah.
Fake the pitch. Burke Lillard on the keeper. Burke gets free inside the 50. Still on his feet. 45-40 down to the right sideline. 30, 25, 20, 15. And still on his feet inside the 10 and in for a touchdown. Kept his feet in bounds and Burke Lillard makes some magic happen. It's a 50-yard touchdown run. And the Lakers have put up another TD.
Whew. That was a run by Lillard there, and that's just some bad tackling by Benjamin Logan. And, they tried to force him out. He stayed in, cut back into the middle of the field, and to the house he goes for another six on the board and brings up this PAT brought to you by Fissel's Floor Covering, covering a reputation you can stand on.
Cummins, the PAT kick, it is up, and it is good again. 7:20 to play in the third quarter of play, and our score on the Quest Federal Credit Union scoreboard is 48-0 Indian Lake. Let's take a break and come back with more after this on 98.3 WPKO and PeakofOhioTV.com.
Thinking about cleaning up your property or home? Call Bobcat Multiworks for a dumpster. They offer 10 and 20 cubic foot sizes. They deliver them right to your door and pick them back up. It's the perfect way to dispose of all the things you don't need anymore. Check them out at bobcatmultiworks.com.
Jack and Doe's, a family tradition for over 50 years. Started by the Valentine family in the late 60s, it's now operated by the third generation. They were taught how to make delicious, quality pizza, subs, chicken, and more. Jack and Doe's, home of the original large sheet pizza. Visit their Facebook page or one of their three locations for dine-in, delivery, or carry-out in Kenton, Russell's Point, or Urbana. Jack and Doe's, the tradition lives on.
Touchdown, Indian Lake. They'll kick it off again here on 98.3 WPKO, 48-0. They lead it. Here's our Dairy Queen kick. Kicking it deep. Raiders come up on the run, get it at the 19. Likert, 25, and that's it. Swarm of Lakers will take him down. And it'll be first and 10, and we'll see the Raiders offense for the first time in the second half.
Looks like they got Andrix going back out there.
Really?
Yeah, I've seen 17 walking out there. Yeah, the clock should be rolling anyway, too. But, well, I guess not technically. Got to wait for them to get there. You go, now it'll roll.
Yeah, you're right. It is Hunter Andrix.
Yeah, that boggles me.
That is interesting. He's going to start the second half. I thought they'd roll with the freshman and just let him go. And it's a quarterback keeper for Andrix, and he is stood up, and he's going to actually lose maybe a yard on this one.
I mean, mind boggles me because you're thinking, you know, I get it. You know, he is a junior, but you got a freshman quarterback. Obviously, you got some faith in. He can sling the ball around. Someone's down on the field for the Lakers, or for the Raiders, I'm sorry. But
yeah.
I don't know. I think
it's Hunter Andrix, isn't it?
No, is it? It might be.
Injury timeout on the field here, and I'll tell you what, we'll step away as well with 6:30 to go in the third quarter. It's a timeout on the field, 48-0 Indian Lake. More after this on 98.3 WPKO and PeakofOhioTV.com.
Swing by Lee's Famous Recipe Chicken for the all-new Nashville Hot Mac and Cheese Bowl. With breast strip bites tossed in Nashville Hot flavor, all nestled into a bowl of mac and cheese. It's a meal with a kick. Try the Nashville Hot Mac and Cheese Bowl, only at Lee's.
Looking to save money every month? Well, who isn't? With a Quest MasterCard, you can lock in a low fixed interest rate from 5.99 to 11.9% APR for qualified cardholders. You can even perform balance transfers from other high interest cards and save real money every month. Apply online today. Membership and credit score eligibility required. Quest Federal Credit Union. Explore the possibilities. NCUA insured. Equal opportunity lender.
When you're craving pizza, call Badrone's Pizza of Bell Fountain, 592-1020. You'll get it freshly made just for you. If pizza isn't what you're craving, they have a variety of sandwiches and dinners sure to please. Badrone's Pizza of Bell Fountain, 592-1020.
Do you love that glow your skin gets from the sun? At Buckeye Wash and Tan, you can keep that glow all year round. You don't have to worry about the seasons changing either. They have several beds available to help you achieve and keep the look you want. Check out Buckeye Washington at either of their two Bell Fountain locations.
Hi, it's Liz at Bell Fountain's Comfort Inn, reminding you we offer your out-of-town guests a comfortable alternative. Available amenities include in-room microwave and fridge, complimentary breakfast, outdoor pool, and on-site lounge. And king rooms come with hot tubs. It really does beat crowding into your house, and we're pet-friendly, too. Reservations are easy at choicehotels.com or call 937-599-5555. That's Bell Fountain's Comfort Inn.
Welcome back to Benjamin Logan. Andrix got up and was able to walk off under his own pressure. That's good. Handoff here on second and long, and nowhere to go for number four, Alex Hassel, as Sully Hughes comes back in for the Raiders on offense to play quarterback here. But Andrix, back to him back away. There's a leg injury, Rick, but yep. The good news is he did walk to the sideline.
He walked to the sideline. He does have his helmet back on, standing back on the sideline here. So we'll see what Coach Jenny decides to do. But I think for this series anyway, I think it's Hughes' show right now for this series.
Yeah. Third down and long, handoff. It's like the Raiders are just, That's going to ring up a fourth down and seven. They might just be content to just run this clock out and get out of here.
I don't know. I'd be I wouldn't think they'd wave the white flag like that, but.
Now three straight running plays, fourth down and seven. And here comes the punt team on.
Man, I know they're throwing some interceptions, but, you know, I tell you what, you know, Hughes, he can sling the ball.
He can. Yep. All right, fourth down. Punt team's in.
See if they get a good snap off this time.
And it's a good snap. The punter, pretty good foot into it. Wobbler, and it'll bounce and take a nice Raider bounce inside the 35-yard line. And the Lakers will set up first and 10 with 4:41 to go in the third quarter. 48-0 Indian Lake. Bell Fountain's also putting it on Tecumseh. That game is now 42-0 with a running clock in the second half down there at Tecumseh. I'll tell you what's not a running clock is the bowl game. 28-27 West Jefferson as they head into the third quarter.
Ooh, that's a close one.
Wow, what a game between two 6-0 teams there.
I'll tell you what, I just looked. That Graham and Shawnee game is final.
I wouldn't be surprised if they had a running clock in the first half, maybe agreed upon by both coaches.
Yeah, maybe, because it's so, you know.
It was let 28-0 out to shoot, I think, right?
Right. The X will say, not even 9 o'clock, I mean, you're 8:50 in to have a final already.
Yeah, yeah. First and 10, Lakers. Starters are in there, but we think it's going to go through the third quarter. Handoff, Cosby. Hit at the line, falls forward for a couple. Like to think. Byhalia.net, providing internet for tonight's broadcast here in the booth. Byhalia.net is a locally owned, family-operated wireless internet service provider. They serve Logan, Union, Hardin, and Marion counties. They got high-speed wireless internet since 2002. Check out their website, Byhalia.net, and learn more information.
Check that. They got a different QB than the Lake does. I don't see two out there.
You're right. It's three.
That's his brother.
That's Madden Lillard. I had a Lillard in there, but not.
Yeah,
not
right.
Madden.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're right. So Burke is not.
That's interesting.
Playing the quarterback, it's Madden. And he hands off to Cosby. Cosby falls through the hole and goes forward. It's going to be about 3 yards shy of a first down here. Riverside leads 21-7 right now at Lehman. Boy, I'll tell you what, Riverside gets out of there with a win tonight, and they lose their starting quarterback. That's important because, I mean, it was a 7-7 game at one point when Miles left the ball game.
Yeah, it's. I tell you what, though, that defense is really good for Riverside.
Ballhawks.
Yes, they are.
Third down coming up for the Lakers, 3rd and 3. Clock moving at 3 minutes to play in the third quarter.
They got Clary at tight end over there at Riverside.
Man, I like him.
Yeah, he's good. A little over six, about 6'1".
Yeah.
He's really good.
Two wideout split left. Madden Lillard will hand off. Cosby tries to get through the hole, and nothing there on third down. So it'll be fourth down coming up for the Lakers, 4th and short, but probably a punt, I would imagine, inside their own 40-yard line and already at 48-0.
Yeah, because here comes Burke Lillard back on, so evidently he's coming on to punt the ball.
He's going to punt, yeah.
That's a weird series. I didn't know his brother. I guess we've never seen the backups very often, but I'm almost positive I didn't remember his brother being a backup.
Right. Well, maybe they're just trying to get some first-team reps but not get Burke. High snap. Burke pulls it in. Now he's going to tuck and run. All kinds of Raiders around him. He's just going to get out of bounds, and it'll be a turnover on downs officially here for Indian Lake on a muffed punt. High snap. And that's one thing that John Rapp doesn't want to see. Not only that they turn it over on the downs with a bad snap, but his starting quarterback's out there going,
yeah,
still almost getting another hit when you're eyeing a major game next week. So the Raiders take over. As it's 1st and 10 at the Laker 33-yard line. 48-0 our score here. Indian Lake well in front. Hughes back to work for the Raiders. And they are play action. Now they're going to throw. And they fire and they get their man out of the backfield. That's Plykard. Plykard breaks one tackle and then he's thrown down from behind as he's going to pick up 8 yards down to the 25.
They like run that little screen play there. That's about the third or fourth time tonight they've ran that screen play. And it's been successful every time they've ran it. I tell you what, Hughes just kind of slings that ball right in there to the open back, and some nice blocking up front there by the Benjamin Logan Raiders.
Tell you what, we always like to tie in a lot of things over here. Gavin Osborne is actually playing quarterback at Riverside tonight, and he is a cousin of the Lillards.
Oh, wow.
So it all ties in. Thanks to Scott Jackson for the info over there at Riverside at the Riverside game tonight. Hughes to throw. Middle of the football field, picked off. And that's our guy again.
Yeah, Quest Clay.
Quest Clay comes away with the pick on the fourth pick of the night, right?
Yes.
Yeah, fourth pick of the night, sixth turnover. And turn it over with 107 to go here in the third quarter. And a 48-0 lead for Indian Lake. They'll take over at their own 10-yard line.
That is Hughes just trying to make a play, and he just stared down the receiver the whole time. And Quest Clay's like, yeah, I'll take that one.
First and 10.
Let's see who's going
out. It's Madden Lillard.
Yeah, Madden's out there. They got looks like he's running second team reps. You might have the Cos out there, but no starting wide receivers out there right now.
Hand off, Cosby. Through the hole, out to the 14-yard line, where he'll pick up 4 yards.
Yeah, you don't have Quest Clay out there anywhere starting. Obviously, you got Madden running the QB, so he's taken out of his wide receiver position.
Yeah.
So they definitely got some fresh bodies out there. And third quarter's almost over, so I guess we're probably about right. You know, hey, end of third quarter, they're pulling the plug.
They do have to run one more play here before the end of the quarter. As the play clock's at 16 and the game clock's at 19. Second down, 6. Madden Lillard keeps it himself, goes to the right side. Madden across the 20, 25, 26-yard line. He'll have a first down, and that will end the third quarter of play out here at Benjamin Logan. Running clock, 48-0 in favor of Indian Lake and our Quest Federal Credit Union High School football scoreboard. Back with the fourth quarter after this on 98.3 WPKO and PeakofOhioTV.com.
Just one visit and you'll know why it's worth the drive to Firehouse Pizza in Zanesfield. This weekend, try a specialty pizza like the Fireman's Italian. Think about an Italian sub on a pizza. Or the mac and cheese with ranch, bacon, and 4 different cheeses. Firehouse Pizza. Check their Facebook page for specials.
Looking for a way to make your gun even more awesome? Come down to Patriot's Attic and get yourself a silencer. We take care of all the paperwork and fingerprints in-house, so the most stressful part for you is deciding which can to buy. The best part? When you buy a silencer at Patriot's Attic, you're free to take it out of jail and use it on our range whenever you want while you're waiting for that form to be approved. So make that wait time worth it and come see us on County Road 130 between Huntsville and Bell Fountain.
Dream about a pool for your family? Advanced Pools of Ohio has your summer fun in mind. From choosing the right pool size to professional installation, maintenance, and the chemicals to keep your pool looking great all season long. Find them at advancedpoolsofohio.com or check out the store located on 273 outside of Bell Center. Advanced Pools of Ohio.
We go to the final quarter here at Benjamin Logan High School. It's 48-0 Indian Lake in front here on WPKO. All Lakers out here tonight in the backyard brawl. We'll have a first and 10 for Indian Lake to start the fourth quarter at their own 26-yard line, as they're just pretty much running out the clock out here. Backups are in. And there's a handoff. And Cosby through the hole. Cosby to the 40, 45, and then wrestled down after another huge pickup there. He's going to grab about 20 yards on that scamper. Well, Cosby is still in there. But other than that, backup quarterback in. Now Cosby's going to come out.
Yep. We say, yeah, okay, guy, you're done too. You got that first down. You had some nice carries tonight. Got some nice positive yards. And the cause is out.
Colin Bendler will come in to spell him. He's a freshman. Tonight's game is brought to you by Easton Water Solutions, where they live and breathe water. Also, the Liberty Gathering Place in West Liberty, serving up homemade dishes all day long. First and 10 at the 47. And low snap, Bendler picks it up. He's on the rush, and he's tackled for a loss. A big loss on the play back at the 42. So he lost 5 yards. I tell you what, we've seen some bad snaps tonight.
Yeah, I haven't seen very many from Laker this year. And I tell you what, I don't know if that's a backup center or not out there, but definitely I think if you're Coach Rapp, you're working on that that snap come next week, because you do not want to have some bad snaps going on that showdown next week over there against Shawnee.
No, they're going to have to play four quarters of good football next week. Tonight's game is brought to you by Cracked Pot Studio. Check out their Facebook page for available classes at Cracked Pot Studio. Buckeye Wash and Tan is your full-service laundromat and tanning salon. Second and 15, Lakers handoff. Bendler goes to the left side. Bendler picks up 5-6 yards and then stuff there. A third and 9 coming up. Want to thank Fazoli's. Tonight's game is brought to you by Fazoli's of Bellefontaine. Great Italian food at Fazoli's there on South Main. They're open after the game if you'd like to stop by. Elevate Chiropractic. Take control of your health with Bellefontaine's newest chiropractic clinic. Go online to elevatechirocare.com. Third down and 9 coming up here for the Lakers. Clock moving, 9:40 to play in the ballgame. Coming up on Ron's Pizza postgame show, guys have plenty to talk about tonight. Kinds of good scores and some blowouts. There's a drop snap, and boy, Madden Lillard's got a fall on it for a big loss on the play. Back inside the 45 near the 43, 42-yard line. Fourth down coming up, punt time for the Lakers. Want to thank Jack and Doe's Pizza. They are the home of the original sheet pizza. Jack and Doe's at the lake. Punt time here for the Lakers. Good snap. Punt is out. Takes a Laker bounce. Goes out of bounds. See where they mark it out. Raiders will take over first and 10 here with just under 9 minutes to go in the ballgame at the 31-yard line. Also thanks to Patriots Attic. Lock it, load it, love it. Patriots Attic in Huntsville, your Logan County Firearms Headquarters. Well, Rick, we're going to have 7 weeks in the books here after tonight. And what do you think after 7 weeks?
So I think, Tail, you had some teams out there that you know coming into the season in high school football that were going to be really good. I think they've shown it. You've had some teams out there that – we're looking for a great season. Maybe had a couple letdown games here and there. And then you got some ones that are just really trying to find themselves still. And unfortunately, we're watching one of them teams tonight. And, you know, they make some – Benjamin Logan's made some good plays, but they're definitely,
it's a building.
Looking to build some more stuff, yeah.
Hassel on the carry is going to take it out to the 38-yard line, setting up a second down and 3.
And we mentioned earlier, nothing against the Raiders, but with the Lakers, even Coach Rapp himself, said that, if you're looking at saying, you're 4-2, 1-0 in the division, yeah. And he's like, man, that's farther ahead than what I would have thought.
Well, they went 1-9 last year.
Yeah.
So, 4-2. Now they're looking to go 5-2. That's a great turnaround. And, oh, wow, nice tackle out there as Charles Sickles Sposa. It's a nice tackle right there. It's going to be 3rd down and 2 coming up. But, 1-9, you go in here. And Indy Lake came in here. They didn't have a lot returning.
Correct.
Burke Lillard he played some at quarterback last year. He didn't play the whole season. So, you had that. You had new skill positions. Quest Clay's pretty much, he's coming into his own now this year. So, they had a lot to build this year for Indy Lake. Quick pass out of the backfield caught. Plykert's got it for a 1st down, 45, and still on his feet across the 50, and then pushed out of bounds right at the Indian Lake sideline here with 7:20 to go in the ballgame.
Yeah, I think when you're looking at the Lakers, and even though the game was a loss, I think where you had Quest Clay's coming out party was when they played Bellefontaine. I think Coach Rapp realized, hey, not saying he didn't realize he had something there, but, I think that really built the confidence. Again, like I said, it was a loss, unfortunately, to Bellefontaine, but, man, he had, go over 200 yards receiving, I think, there in that game.
Yeah, oh, wow, we're going to penalty flag somewhere on Indian Lake or on Benjamin Logan in this. So that's going to back him up, gate a big play. 48-0 Indian Lake in front. Clock will move with 7:12 to go in the ball game here. And I really think, it's hard to say one game changes a whole season, but I think that Allen East game just changed Indian Lake's whole year. They came from behind, they win that game, then they come from behind the next week and beat Tecumseh. I just think that one game really propelled them to where they are today. Hughes to throw, pump fakes, comes back, and he's going to hit his man for a screen. 35, making a couple moves to the 40-yard line is Hassel, and that'll be short of the first down by a yard. It'll be fourth down and one.
You know, you also look at some of this game and, you know, some of the, you know, perplexed calls. And again, we talked about it earlier there, right there in the second quarter. You know, Benjamin Logan staring down second and one on the plus side of the territory. And they run, you know, three straight pass plays. And it's kind of, you know, it's kind of weird, you know, a little bit. And turned the ball over on downs.
Fourth and one here at their own 40. They're going to run a pitch play out. Hassel's got it. First down, and he's at the 45 at midfield and out of bounds right there. Well, that big showdown in the OHC, the West Jefferson Rough Riders have taken the lead at 35-27 on West Lierty-Salem in the third quarter.
Wow.
So that means they have now outscored the Tigers 21-0, right? Wasn't it 27-14?
Yes.
Wow, that's 21-0 West Jeff since that. Tigers need something. They got to get something going now.
Need a touchdown.
Greenview leads Southeastern 18-13. That's another good game in the OHC tonight. Hughes to throw, first and 10 at midfield. Pumping, and he fires out to the left sideline. Incomplete at the 42-yard line. And it'll be second down with the clock at 5 minutes to go in the ballgame. High school football, 98.3 WPKO, Bell Fountain. Welcome to Benjamin Logan here tonight. Rick Zedeker, Chad Wilkinson here. Lou Vito, Gary Kauffman running things at PeakofOhioTV.com. Where it's been all Indian Lake. 27-0 in the first quarter, and they've never looked back. 48-0.
I tell you, one showdown, too, that's happening that's a close one. London Red Raiders, Jonathan Alder, Pioneers, tied up at 35 apiece.
Wow. What a good game there. Hughes to throw on second and 10. Looks in the middle of the field. Has Dillbone for a catch. He's going to pick up 3 yards. Third down coming up. So it'll be third and 7 on the way. Boy, how about that showdown in the CBC, though? 35 all?
35 all.
Jonathan Alder. And I had heard that that Cameron Jewell was hurt for Jonathan Alder, but I don't know.
Oh, wow.
He's the leading rusher in the CBC.
Right. Hey, check that, Chad. 33-35, West Lierty-Salem and Rough Riders.
All good. The Tigers scored.
Yeah.
Third down for the Raiders. Hughes fires out high on the right sideline, incomplete. Fourth down coming up here with 3:55 to go in the ballgame.
Assuming they must have went, West Lierty-Salem must have went for two, baby.
Maybe they're getting ready to.
Or maybe they are, too, yeah.
Yeah, that game's happening on the bowl, by the way, 106-9. That was an important score by the Tigers, not only to, you know, stay close in it, but to break a 21-0 skid that they were on. West Jeff had outscored them 21-0 since they were up 14-7. Timeout, Benjamin Logan with 3:33 to play in the ballgame. 48-0, Indian Lake in front. Let's step away from Benjamin Logan. More after this on 98.3 WPKO and PeakofOhioTV.com.
When you're hungry for great Italian food, but you're also in a hurry, try Fazoli's of Bell Fountain. They offer delicious Italian meals like spaghetti and meatballs and chicken Alfredo fettuccine. They also offer great pizza and oven-baked subs. Be sure to download their rewards app. You'll get special offers, plus every dollar you spend, you get reward points to spend on future purchases. Fazoli's of Bell Fountain, open till 9.
We're back to Benjamin Logan here on WPKO and PeakofOhioTV.com. Timeout Benjamin Logan before a fourth down play at the Lakers 47-yard line. It's fourth down and 7.
Yeah, I'll tell you, we're talking about the scores, but I think one thing that's really interesting, Chad, is the Waynesfield Goshen Tigers. Mm-hmm. They're up 31-16 over Elgin.
Wow.
They said they weren't even off the field there. The coaches weren't. But what is that? What you said, that 17 regular season?
This would be 19 in a row regular season wins for the Tigers tonight with that win up there. What did you say, 31-16?
31-16,
so they
yeah.
almost doubled them up there. And that was a 12-8 game at halftime.
Yep.
Fourth down for Benjamin Logan. And they're going to pass. Hughes slings it out of the backfield. Got it. And good open field tackle. They're going to tackle him short for the first down. Hassel got to the 41, but he needed the 40. So they're going to come up a yard short. Turn it over on downs. The Lakers will come out and run this clock out pretty much. There's 3:08 to go. They can pretty much run it out. A first down definitely puts it out.
Yep. That was a great open field tackle by the Lakers right there. Man, shots him. He looked like, you're like, he's got it. And, man, he just hits him and makes him shop or stops him short of the sticks right there.
41-yard line for Indian Lake. As they'll come out of here celebrating a victory over their rivals, by the way. And more importantly for them, 5-2. And further solidifying themselves in their region to clinch a playoff here in the next few weeks, hopefully, for Indian Lake. Still got a lot of work to do.
Yeah, a lot of work.
There's three games left to go. But Indian Lake, if you're a Laker fan now, you need these teams to start winning who you've beaten this year. Like, you've got to be looking at the scoreboard tonight. Allen East is playing Spencerville. They need to win. High snap. Here's a handoff. And taking it to the 40, a loss of one on that play. Bendler with 2:40 to go in the game. Benjamin Logan will bring in a massive bunch of subs on defense, get some of the second-teamers in there with 2:32 to go. But, yeah, I mean, you're rooting for Allen East. You need Tecumseh to get a win. I don't know if Tecumseh's going to be able to get another win this year. They lost to Kenton Ridge already in that part of the CBC. And they're gonna, it's a tough schedule, but they could use a Tecumseh win somewhere along the line. Fairbanks. They need Fairbanks to win. Hand off to Bendler. Going to be third down coming up. Let's see what Fairbanks is doing tonight. They're getting pounded by Mechanicsburg. See, 47-7. That's not helping.
Doesn't help them.
Doesn't help the Lakers.
No. Same with Urbana. We talked about it earlier, and, you know, they're sitting there at 5-1 and outside looking in right now.
Well, that's what happened. They play a weak schedule.
Yeah.
And they have, I think they might have some of the smallest second-tier points you're ever going to find because their teams just haven't won any games that they've beaten this year. Now, Kenton Ridge is going to be a good win for them tonight. Pick up some points there. Bendler, shoestring tackle as he gets to the 46. Fourth down coming up here with a minute 35 to go in this ball game. But Kenton Ridge, who's in their region, by the way, who's 4-2, is actually many slots ahead of Urbana.
Yeah.
Just because of the teams that they've beaten this year.
Looks like Lake's going to punt it away, run it. I mean, if I'm them, I'm running this. They got 28 seconds left on the play clock. Just run this thing all the way down.
Yeah, they'll run it well inside a minute. Gavin Osborne has thrown his third touchdown pass for Riverside. They now lead Lehman 28-14. So the Pirates, boy, pays to have a good backup.
Yeah, it does.
Low snap picked up by the punter, and he boots it out of there. Lillard gets it away, takes a Laker bounce, and will be down inside the 20-yard line of Benjamin Logan with 46 seconds to go in the ball game. And the Raiders will come out for another snap or two before this one wraps up officially out here at Benjamin Logan High School. But, I mean, as we look in here now, I mean, 7 weeks are going to be in the books, 3 weeks to go in the seasons. We're going to be looking at playoff standings, playoff points, stuff like that, top 16 in each region get in. As we stand today, teams like Bellefontaine, Indian Lake, West Liberty-Salem, Riverside, all looking at that. We're thinking Urbana should be able to get in, but, man, they've got to get a couple more wins.
I tell you what, Bellefontaine needs to beat Urbana next week, but Urbana needs to beat Bellefontaine to get them points.
They both need that win next
week.
Big points. And then if you want to host games, you got to get as many points as you can to start hosting. Handoff on first down for the Raiders. And scampering out across the 25 and just short of the 30-yard line. Let's see if they get up and run one more play here before this one ends.
Doesn't look like they're in that big of a hurry. You got 18 seconds left. Well,
so, I mean, if you get in the top eight in your region, you're going to host one playoff game. If you get in the top four, you could, I mean, of course, you got to win, host two playoff games. That's so important.
Yes.
Especially in some of these places, you got to go an hour, hour and a half. And that's the ball game. They didn't get the snap off, so Indian Lake comes in here tonight and knocks off the rival Benjamin Logan Raiders with our final score of 48-0 here on 98.3 WPKO and PeakofOhioTV.com. Rick, final thoughts on the ball game out here.
You know, I think the Lake continues to improve. You know, they're doing what they should be doing out there. You know, we talked about them earlier. We've seen them earlier in the season, seen them a couple times this year, and I think every week they're starting to gel and get some more active players into their offense. Little bit of a sloppy second quarter for the Lakers. You know, if you're going to downfall to many, so you want to clean that up a little bit. And I tell you what, you know, coming off that win, you know, Benjamin Logan had last week, and to come back home and get, you know, shut out is definitely not the direction you want to go. But I think there's a lot of work left to do for Benjamin Logan. I think they're still trying to figure out an identity, possibly an offense, where they want to go. You know, they're running kind of a dual quarterback here a little bit. So I think they got to get that, you know, figured out. What direction does Coach Jenny want to go there? But, you know, again, excellent win for the Lakers, beating your cross-county rival. And, you know, unfortunately for the Lakers, I mean, that's a tough, tough loss to have. But, you know, they have to look and try to pick the positives out from this one and build from it.
Well, Indian Lake's got to get back to work next week. They got Shawnee in town for what would be the showdown in the CBC Mad River. That's for sure. Both teams will be 2-0 in the Mad River. That's at Indian Lake High School next Friday night. That's a major, major showdown next week. Let's look at some of the scoring out here tonight. Indian Lake got on the scoreboard after the first series of the game without their offense even on the field.
Yeah.
Ben Logan went 3 and out. The snap to the punter went through his legs. He went to pick it up, and he got just smashed by two Lakers. The ball was loose on the ground. Cody Reisinger picked it up and ran it in for a touchdown, and that was a 6-0 lead. Then the Lakers got the ball back on an interception. Cosby, a 4-yard touchdown run. Then Quest Clay get on the action, 7-yard touchdown run. Lillard to Reisinger, all in the first quarter, 27-0. Clay, a 50-yard run in the second quarter. Burke to Madden Lillard in the second quarter, 41-0 at the break. One second-half touchdown was a Burke Lillard 50-yard run, 48-0. Your final score here on 98.3 WPKO. And, again, Indian Lake, Mr. Lillard had another solid game. But really, I mean, it was pretty much well-rounded out here tonight.
Yeah, it was well-rounded. I mean, obviously, you know, we talked about it before, the offense does run through him between the pass and the run. And I think it all gels by, you know, if he's on, the team is on. But it was well-rounded. They had a great special teams tonight. The defense was definitely hitting, making some nice sure tackles, not letting the Benjamin Logan Raiders go for any more positive yards than what they actually needed to. And so, again, I think it's well-rounded. And, again, it's hats off to the Indian Lake Lakers and a W tonight. And then the Benjamin Logan Raiders go back to the building blocks.
So next week, Rick and I are heading over to Riverside to see the Pirates take on the Miami East Vikings, as it'll be homecoming for Riverside next week. Riverside in a little bit of a tussle right now with Lehman, 27-21. They lead that game in the second half down there at or over there at Sydney Lehman here tonight. So we'll see Riverside next week here on WPKO, and hopefully they'll be rolling on. I mean, we're expecting them to really compete up there for the TRC.
Yeah, I think I'm excited to go back there to Riverside. I think that, you know, see if they can pull out the W tonight. You know, you got the injury to Miles Platfoot that happened. Sounds like Osborne stepping in and doing okay. But you know, their season, you know, again, you know, they got that 4-year starter Riverside do as their quarterback. So he's kind of, you know, some of the glue for that offense. So it'll be interesting to see how they respond and what shakes out here in the next week.
All right, that's going to wrap us up out here tonight at Benjamin Logan High School. We're going to send it back to the studio. They're going to have the Ron's Pizza postgame show coming up here in just a couple of minutes with some scores and highlights from around the area. Big wins for tonight around the area, too. We'll also be tracking that London-Jonathan Alder game, the West Liberty-Salem-West Jefferson game as well. Those scores are tight as they head into the fourth quarter of play. The Ron's Pizza postgame show is coming up 48-0, our final score here. Indian Lake, a big, big winner over Benjamin Logan tonight. For Gary Kauffman, Lou Vito, Rick Zedeker, I'm Chad Wilkinson saying so long from Benjamin Logan High School.